back.
We're sorry, back. Guys. Yeah, we're back. Let me just bring Dossie back. I would like to hear what Dossie's dating experience and what she does for a living. No idea. Had to be 80s or 90s or after. I don't know. Ask ChatGPT. Oh boy, we're back. Refresh. Refresh, guys. We're back with Dossie. I was here. Everything was fine with Dossie and I, but you guys crashed on me.
We're back. Are we back?
Yeah, we're back.
I don't see you in your live.
Oh, you don't see me? Interesting. Oh, okay.
Well, see hold you on. In my bottom screen. It doesn't matter as long as you can see me.
I can see you.
I can. Okay.
There we go.
There we go. Mm-hmm. Now we're back.
We're back. Yep.
What was the question?
Okay, so we'll get to Bruca's question after, because we're just talking about something else right now, but...
Okay.
Bit lazy, don't have any great need to use it, and that's funny since I have worked up in a garage. I work in IT, and I asked ChatGTP everything. The debut of the Cat, or the Tat 8? I thought it's Cat 8. Was in 1988. Marked the first... Marked the first transatlantic fiber. You got it right. It was in 88, Skiz. So cute when you have to chat to refresh, but they can hear you. They can only hear you if they don't need to refresh again. I see.
Did you know that ChatGPT got beat today by Gemini?
Mm-mm.
Just today.
Is Gemini another AI?
Yeah, it's Google.
Mm.
They beat them in all their parameters, but that was today. And then there's Llama. Llama's right up there. And Meta is really kicking ass.
Meta is Facebook and Instagram, right?
Yep, Zuckerberg. Mm-hmm. And he's going to keep it open source. That is another thing I try to.
What does that mean, open source?
Free to anyone that has, like, now ChatGPT was founded as open source, and then they couldn't afford it, or they decided to monetize it. So now I pay, what do I pay, like $25, $21 a month for it?
Well, damn.
But
that's news to Skiz. He's like, Gemini beat ChatGTP? I'm a Virgo.
Just today.
Wow, just today.
But they'll come back with something else.
Hi, Lit. Vegas is here under my desk. Yeah, they'll come back. It'll be some back and forth axiom.
Yeah. But Zuckerberg is really... I think if you go back to how long Facebook was in play, he's got so much data.
Mm-hmm.
And as long as their argument, Skiz, is if you leave it open source, that you'll have more to work with, your parameters, more information, because more people are going to get on there.
Right.
In a very large scale Wikipedia, very large, but the AI is going to be able to, you know, sort the wheat from the chaff pretty easily. It's fascinating. Absolutely fascinating and terrifying, because you really can't wrap your head around it. I've tried. It's very difficult. It's huge.
Skiz doesn't trust Meta.
Why not? Why wouldn't you? What would make you not trust one over the other? Because I use Grok too.
And it was copper copper wire cables were the first, Safi believes. Back in like the late 1800s for the telephone. It was copper wire cables.
Is that kind of like having
Lady Winnemut just raided with six views.
Is that text? Is that text?
1 second. We got a raid from Lady Wanima.
Hi, lady. Love her. Lovely.
She's great. Venomous Rex.
I love it. I hope he's doing well. I hope your father's doing well. All the best. And I think she broke her arm and she broke her elbow a while back.
Yeah, she fell off a ladder. She got a hairline fracture. Lady Wanima, thank you for the raid, girl. Welcome in, raiders. Yes. If you don't know me already, my name is Anne, and this is my lovely guest, Dossie. Dossie, and she is a fellow streamer as well. A little more sporadic here and there. She's like a fart in the wind, Shvies. Like a fart in the wind. Venomous Rex. Yes. So, and we're just doing some e-dates tonight. Saturday night are our e-date nights. And bring on different guests. We kind of shoot the shit. A meeting of the minds, so to speak. So that's
well,
what's going on.
We're getting some fun facts.
We really are. As a group, yeah. It's kind of fun because we're finding things out together as a community, which is interesting. Venomous Rex says, first time chatter, A, welcome in, first time chatter. Yeah, I was going to say, if you can't trust Meta, what about Twitch? What about Twitch if you can't trust Meta? Good question, Venomous Rex. You can still regulate freedom of AI speech and answers. Now you all have my full attention. Ah, nice lady. I hope your stream went well. Did we shout out Lady? Yeah. What were you playing, Lady? Were you playing Fortnite? They got... Okay, so Skiz re-meta. They have too much privacy issues with intuitively predicting your behavior. Yeah, they spy in on you. That's true.
But aren't they all?
They're too good with their Facebook data. They can read you like a book. If you got a change, a chance, check out the movie The Social Dilemma. Great movie. I've never heard of it.
What about Amazon? Anybody who has an Alexa, all of a sudden you're talking, and then she goes, "Hey, I have a deal for you." And you're like, "Holy shit, how did you know?" They're all, I mean, come on. The algorithms are everywhere, though. So help me with this. I know that Meta has more data right now, but what about Elon Musk? He bought Twitter. Why'd he buy Twitter? It wasn't, I mean, yes, he is for freedom of speech. I love that. But there was a lot of fucking data there.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
That's just my question. I'm not arguing. It's an intelligent conversation that I really would love to hear. Because mm-hmm. I agree, Facebook has a shit ton.
Right.
And Twitter.
Mr. Cairo, you're right. Everyone is spying on you. I don't trust no one. I have several Alexas. I don't even let my dog take a crap without a gun. Facts, Wrinkly. The walls have ears, says I gotta see them all. Amazon gets to know you, how often you wipe your butt, buy its toilet paper, and that's very true.
But how do they know why you're buying toilet paper?
Big tech has a scary side to it.
Oh, definitely. They're horrifying. Definitely. Yeah. There's always an agenda. But you know what?
Not a perfect...
You find it... What?
Not a perfect platform to gather data from.
No. No, because a lot of people that go on one platform have a certain leaning, if you will.
All the OnlyFans girls that pop up in Wrinkly's feed. Sheesh.
Who pops up in Wrinkly's feed?
OnlyFans girls.
Where have you been, Wrinkly? Obviously, he's been somewhere. They don't just pop up.
Check out The Social Dilemma on Netflix. It talks about this. Ooh.
Well, I don't want to be terrified. What about The Matrix?
The walls have ears, and everything is being monitored. That's like The Matrix, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. I mean, look at people who have all your security cameras. I mean, come on. Everything we say is being watched. Every upload from here, even Lady Winmina when she's gaming, the games, everything. What are you gonna do? I mean, what do we do? There's nothing you can do.
That reminds me, Lady Winmina, what were you playing today? Did we shout you out?
Lady, we love you.
By the way, her dad, he's doing better. And she has, yeah, he's doing better, and she has two fractures. We did shout you out. She was playing golf with friends. Two fractures in her elbow, and her dad is doing better. Good to know, lady. Good to know.
Well, I'm happy about your father. I'm not so happy for you. I just hope you have very good medication.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Alexa and Cortana's and GPT and the Google Homes, they're collecting so much data.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she was shouted out. Mm. And Dossie's right. What the fuck we supposed to be do? What the fuck we supposed to do besides move into the mountains? I'm not opposed to moving into the mountains, frankly, Skiz, though.
Well, I'm not either if I have the certain modern conveniences of UPS dropping my shit off. Because I personally do not like to go out and get very people-y. I'm not a fan of that.
People-y. I like that. I like how you call it people-y. Yeah, you got to be prepared. You have to be in that mental capacity to deal with people, frankly.
Well, you got to be on, because yeah. You're like, how are you? And you just literally like somebody dumped a load of shit on your head and you're like, I'm great. How are you? It's so nice to see you. And then you try to extricate and you can't get out.
Right.
So I'm saying.
Do we really care about general data if we get on Twitch with Cam, talk about our life opinions, and say our name?
They already know who we are. We had to sign up. They already know.
It's a certain level of privacy. Like, I know that I'm putting myself out there right now. I'm authorizing that. The difference is I'm not authorizing all these big companies to monitor my purchase history, my search history. That's kind of without my permission, kind of sneakily, without my knowledge. That's, I think, the difference. That's why it's creepy. I fully know I'm on the internet talking with you guys right now, and I consent to that. So I think it's kind of like a consent thing.
It is. But what about in your throne list? Your Amazon list? I mean, to me, I am fascinated by forensics. I'm fascinated by profiling. Where somebody can walk in and look exactly like, look at what I have here, and they can tell a shit ton about me. That, by your list, has gone to the infinite power. Because before it was a human being that would come in and was brilliant, that would say, okay, well, this is a very detailed person, highly educated. They know this person. They likely hang out alone, or they likely hang out with beautiful blonde women on Saturday nights. That's what they prefer. They drink this. They eat tofu. They already know this. So if Amazon looks at our list, what do they know? It's just like, that's where I have this problem in my head, because it can't just, it's so much.
Right. So who does that? I'm not sure, Mr. Cairo. I will tell you something that I'm concerned and don't approve. Tell me, what are you concerned about and don't approve of? excuse him. What? Bruh. Thank you. Cheers. Bruh. Google can tell you if I had a baby or not and what gender you are and if you're married just by your searching and your app usage. Yeah. They try to learn all of that pertinent information. So, Bruca says that every call and text message on phone, WhatsApp, Viber, etc. is recorded without my permission. Oh yeah, that's not cool, Bruca. I don't like that.
Well, that's what I was going to say. After 9/11, the NSA, there was permission to freely just see and hear everything. Everything.
Mm-hmm.
So...
Woo!
I'm sure that's still a thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because everybody forgot.
We basically authorized that. Right. That was a 9.5 out of 10 belch. I'll take that. That's a freaking Olympic gold, in my opinion. Got me. Thank you. Thank you. Chi-Town says, okay, this is what I wonder about. It took about a week to find out all sorts of info of a young man that shot the president. Trump now, or former President Trump, now imagine if the government gets its arson gear and uses AI software to download info on a subject in real time in the same amount of info. Scary. Yeah.
There was somebody who just joined and gave all their information to the military today. Was that Gemini? I just saw that. And the military has already had this, but there was one of these that just gave it today.
Yeah, Bruca's saying they can use that information against you in court.
Which part?
Bruca, maybe in Serbia. Here they can't, unless it's a homicide. Like, there's certainly certain offenses. They can tap your phone and then use that information against you in a court. But they have to basically get a warrant to tap your phone and use that information. They can all listen, but they can't use that information against you in a court of law unless it's certain offenses. And with those certain offenses, they can get a warrant to tap your phone.
Yes.
Homicide being one of them. Yeah. So.
I think violent crimes.
But yeah.
Then
treason. I think treason, spying, homicide. There's certain things.
Well, treason seems to be, you know, now we're getting into an area where I'm really passionate about, because treason seems to be not really a thing anymore.
How so, Dossie? How is it not a thing anymore? Hi, Warhand. Welcome in.
Well, I mean, at risk of sounding political, I'm not really. I was watching those congressional... Oh, listen, the church bells are ringing.
Well, that's nice.
Isn't that lovely?
It is. I love it when they...
The only thing I can count on is 9 o'clock at night. Otherwise, they get confused during the day. I don't know what's up with that, but... I'm like, oh, what time is it? 10 o'clock? No, it's supposed to be 9. I don't know who's doing this. But, you know, I started watching the congressional hearings regarding with the director of the Secret Service. And she was giving nothing. I mean, I don't recall. I don't have that information. Woman... If you are in charge of the Secret Service and a high target individual, you would have had that information a second afterwards, and bitch, you would have been there. So
right?
I question like so much about that. And she, in my opinion, the information that she was not giving or giving, and the proof that is coming out, which some people say is that deep fake. I don't think so. But treason, she should have been charged with treason. Because if you look back, way back, she'd already lost her head. Because it would have appeared, not saying that that was the case, it would have appeared that she knew and allowed it to happen. That's all I'm saying.
Right.
What's chat got?
Chat, okay, Bruka wants to come on. I already tried to bring on a couple people, like poor Mr. Cairo came on and he was freezing. I can maybe bring this to Discord. And that would work in Discord. I can bring multiple people, no problem, in Discord. Do we want to bring this chat to Discord? So Bruka, hop in. Okay, Bruka, I'm going to pull you up into a channel, a private channel, right now. Okay.
I'm going to have to call my resident IT person.
To go, yeah, you can call your resident IT person to bring you to Discord.
Okay.
And I'll drag you up. Okay. I will drag you to a private channel, and then I've got to... Give me 1 second. I can bring multiple people on Discord. Like, we can make this a real thing. Like, this could be, you know, 6 people, 8 people, whatever, what have you, in Discord. It doesn't...
Okay, so my IT person is saying, do we need to go off of this, and then we're going to go to Discord?
Yeah, I'm going to end, like, with you right now. I'm going to take a quick tinkle. A quick pee break. Okay. And Dossie, you go, you take a quick pee break, you powder your nose, and you just go into my Discord voice channel. Okay?
Okay.
And so you can connect your camera there in Discord. But okay. I'll wait till I pull you up into a mod voice chat, and then you'll connect your camera there. Okay?
Okay, she's got it.
Yeah. It's pretty easy.
BRB.
BRB. Okay. Okay. See you in a bit. Bye, bye, bye. All right. Okay, guys. I'm going to... Like I said. Okay, I'm going to end stream together because, honestly, we're going to do this in Discord. There's not that many people in Discord. I'm only going to bring in people I know in Discord, okay? It's not going to be random people. So, Mr. Cairo, if you'd like to come in, like I promised you, I'm a woman of my word. You can come in, Mr. Cairo. Shy can come in if he wants. Bruka, Dossie, like, please, if I know you, you can come in. But if I don't know you, I won't drag you up into the private channel. Okay. You're figuring it out, Mr. Cairo. Come into my Discord. Bruka, I have you in that channel. Hang tight there. I vote for Skiz, Data, and myself. Anyone, if Skiz wants to come on just with his voice, he can. I will give a special exception to SkizTech. So he could just come in my Discord, voice, no cam, because I know he doesn't want to really show himself, which is understandable. Guys, I'm not lying, I do have to pee. Skiz, you can come in the Discord, I'll drag you in. You can talk just with your voice if you want. We're gonna have a little party. But let me do one thing first. I have to deactivate my cam here. I'm still here, guys. Don't worry about me. I'm still here. Let me go Discord. Let me go close this thing here. Don't worry about that. Just minimize that shit. Let me go into Discord right now. Okay, hold on. Let me get my cam going. Okay, and why is this not showing? Let me pop it out. Actually, I'll just go like this.
Hold on. Okay, I can hear loud and clear.
Okay, good. Where's your camera, Bruka?
Oh, I'm gonna turn my camera on. Don't worry about
it. Okay, good.
You just do your thing.
All right, let me just figure out. Let me figure this out. Let's pop this out. All right. And oops. Bobby Stoops. Sorry. Bear with me, guys, because I'm just a noob. Just frankly, I'm a freaking noob. I have to figure out why my... There should be a video somewhere. I said Bobby, but you guys can't see me. Hold on. Let me figure out the video. Why is the... Why is there no video? There should be a window, like a... Maybe I'll make a new one.
No, I can see on Discord.
Yeah, but no, they can't see me on stream. So, we're gonna make a new... Guys, is it a display capture? Data. Do I have to make a display capture or a window capture? Window capture, right?
Yeah, window.
Yeah, window capture. Add new display. So it's display capture. I know you can't see me. Don't worry, you will in just 1 second. Welcome in, first time chatter. It's you want it to be display capture wrinkly? Okay, we'll do display capture. I'm a ghost. Don't we want window capture though? I think it's gonna be window capture. I think. Okay, and let me change the window to my pop out for Discord. This. Yeah, good. Hello? Greetings. Okay, let me just minimize this a little bit. We're gonna bring in some people. We're back. Okay, I'm gonna go to the washroom really quickly. Bruca, so talk. Can you guys hear Bruca?
Yeah, I'm here. Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah, you can hear. They can hear you. Turn you down. You're actually very loud. Okay, good. So,
okay.
You're good though. You're good.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I'm like that. So sorry
no
about
worries.
That.
No worries. Okay. If anyone wants to come in that knows me, let me know. I'll drag you guys up. Okay. From just like go hang in a voice channel, like a general chat, and I'll pull you up. But I have to use the washroom really quickly, so hang tight. But room for me too. Okay, hold on, I'll be back. Let me just tinkle.
Yeah, Brata, you can come and join. Wrinkle, are you coming as well? Yeah, I'm doing great. How about yourself, bro?
Oh my joys.
No, hello, bro. How you doing, man?
You know what they say.
What they say?
It do be like that sometimes, man.
No, they say, what do they say, like?
Okay, so guys, I'm in Dingle. Which is already known, you guys already know. I'm gonna bring you up. Who's here? Okay, Lady Unima, let me bring you up. Wrinkly's already in there. Wrinkly's just like,
just got back.
I'm coming.
Just got back. I beat you. I beat you. I'm
trying to drag you up. Hold on.
I can leave if you want, but like,
Lady Unima, get up there.
I do think it is important, though, to explain to people.
We can do it like that.
Data is called Snazzy Snazzy Pepperoni.
Drake up.
That's awesome.
Who's C? I can't tell.
Bing.
We got the room, Mr. Cairo. It's a party in here. So.
Oh, shit.
But where's the video? Why did the video go like that? Hold on.
Probably because I don't have mine own.
Hold on. So why?
Well, you usually have one.
Where's the pop out? Like, that I had. How do I get this shit again?
Holy shit, I just beat the fuck out of my mic.
You've popped out the window, player, to another window. Where the hell is the other window? Oh, there it is. Ah, there we are. Okay. I'm sorry, guys. I'm a dingle.
I can see everyone.
Yeah.
Okay, take your Bruca, fucking sunglasses on.
No,
Cupcake.
Bruca, what did you do? You got in a fight or something? What happened? Who's this muted person?
Yeah,
who's this gray muted person?
That's Chai. Chai Town.
Oh, Chai. Hi, Chai.
Chai did not get in a fight. Bruca did. Take your fucking glasses off, Cupcake.
Yeah.
No, bro. I had like the MMA fight.
No, you didn't.
You know, I'm not looking good right now. Yeah, I did.
Did you win or did you lose?
No, I lost.
That's fair. Okay. So can we see?
Yeah. No, not really. I don't want to show up.
Oh, dude,
it's not because of you guys. It's because of
you'd have like shit thing. All the way down here.
Let me just bring the Dossi up. Okay, we got Dossi. All right. So
do you want me to show you?
There's Bay.
Do you want me to show you how bad it is?
Why is it not showing Dossi in here though?
That's what
she's
I'm
in
asking.
Here.
I have a colorborn broken here. So I'm blue all over here, so.
Why is that like that?
So take your shirt off. Show me that ass.
I can show you that in private. Not
there
in
she
here.
Is. Right. It's fine.
I don't do that for free.
He looks like who's that guy who always wears sunglasses that just got
well,
accused of talking to a 15-year-old girl? What's his name?
Let's relax on that, dude.
Yeah, you know,
we don't know. We don't know if he got in a fight yet.
Dr. Disrespect got accused of...
He's canceled,
basically. Yeah.
Yep.
He can dunk, at least.
Well, anyways, hello, Bruca. Hello, Lady Manima. Hello, Dossi. Hello, the real Mr. Cairo. Hello, Wrinkly Beef. Hello. And
I talk to you every day.
Yeah, I don't have a camera, so that's the only reason why I'm still.
I know, Shy.
I don't even have a picture of myself on my.
I've actually never
channel.
Seen even a
I
photo.
I can imagine.
It's true.
How tall are you?
Well, me?
His name is Shy, right?
Yeah, Shy
like
Town.
Chicago.
Like Chicago.
Oh, Chicago. South
side.
What are we doing, Pooh? I don't even know what we're doing, frankly. We're gonna talk. That's
we're
what
gonna
we're doing.
Jerk all of each other off here.
No, then I'm out.
Oh my God. I fold.
What?
This is not a circle work. Jerk, Wrinkly. What did you think you were signing up for?
Hold my camera's not working. Hold up.
It was working earlier, like while you were in Discord. It was working. You were standing up. There you go. Oh.
Fuck.
My only goal here was to explain to people in chat how AI works. Or at least
hey,
Snazzy wants
up.
In.
Oh, I'm listening.
Hold on, let me get Snazzy. I have to wrangle her.
But
hold on.
Come on, Snazzy!
Don't worry, because I understand that people who have never worked in the field, I get it. I totally get it, man.
It's a super interesting field as well these days.
Oh, she doesn't actually want to get in. I guess she's coming. She wants to come in for the circle jerk.
She's on my back, right. Actually. You just can't see her. So she's wearing camo right now.
I thought you were serious. So,
Jesus.
I was being pretty fucking serious, yeah. All right, later.
People dropping off left, right, and center.
She'll be back.
Dude, Cairo, good to fucking meet you, man.
And you, man.
Cheers. Happy Sunday, guys.
An Englishman, eh?
Cheers.
Mm. Very much so.
From where?
I don't know
where
what
are
that
you
means,
from, Cairo?
But...
Where?
I live in the northeast of England. So it's always cold and terrible. But apart from that, it's great. Love it.
Nice.
I've got aircon over there.
Probably got
the
good ass grass.
About 100 miles with air. Oh, that's great.
Your mic sounds like dog shit.
Really?
But yeah. Like, I mean,
no.
You know, just
no, he sounds like a proper gentleman to me.
Hey, relax.
He is a proper gentleman. He is. Think we
just check this out.
You called him. So let's not do that, okay? We have to respect everybody's pronouns.
Gorgeous queen.
Yeah, can we all please take a fucking moment for how fucking good Dossie looks today? Please.
Oh my god, thank you. Thank you so much.
Gorgeous queen.
Please.
We lost
Mr. Kyra.
All
you queens.
Yeah.
Can you see me?
Oh yeah, we can see you.
Oh good. Yeah. Then I won't do anything really weird.
don't pick your nose.
Is Dossie Zakaria?
Yes.
Something like that, yeah. I think so.
Oh yeah. You have a class, definitely. I was watching for you all the time. I think it's the second time that I see you on an e-date, and you did great both of the times.
You're the
Thank
one
you.
From the Balkans, right?
Well, Anne and I have dated multiple times.
Yes, we
and
have.
And I want to join.
Do you really?
Sign me up.
I look at Lady Wolfman and she's like, whoop, there it is.
I'll ask my mom for like $2,000. I'll take you both out. I'll take a
low
down.
They all say they want to ride that ride till they get on it. You know that whole thing where you got to be that tall.
Hold on, I was gonna say I'm worried if I'm tall enough to ride the ride.
Well, we'd let you in.
That's what I'm talking about.
Got the muster.
Hold on. I gotta get Mr. Cairo. He fell out. I don't know. He fell somewhere. So I gotta bring him somewhere. Where are you, Mr.
Stop,
Cairo?
Man. Your Canadian accent is showing.
Is it, Mr. Cairo? Yeah. You have to come back in the chat so I can drag you in. You have to come back into general chat, Mr.
You
Cairo.
Just did it again.
Yeah, Lady W, you get the employee backstage pass. So. Don't worry about it.
I have to tell you, lady, you are looking amazing.
Thank you. I try really hard.
I love it. Love it. Love it. You're beautiful.
Oh, hey, Brinkle, bro, you're looking amazing as well, bro.
What are you, fucking gay?
I'm loving your sunglasses, because I'm a sunglass lady.
He's just being nice.
No, thank you. Just...
He's just being nice.
Yeah, I'm just around. I appreciate it, man.
There we go. That's better.
Oh, I love wrinkly.
Oh, Beefy, everybody just want to just pinch your cheeks. That's what people want to do. So,
gotta catch me first, brother.
Snazzy, you're beautiful too.
Snazzy is beautiful.
Do we have Snazzy?
I'm just saying because we guys didn't got any of the compliments. So, you know, I'm just, you know, sticking out with the guys, with the boys.
Yeah, so like you understand that like I don't trust people with like Russian accents, right? And that's just how I was raised.
Oh, you shouldn't.
Okay, what if I
not like in a bad way?
He's not it's Russian. Just... He's Serbian.
Yeah, but I'm Slav. Yeah, I'm Slav. I know. Yeah, but I'm Slav. Yeah. Mm.
Eastern Bloc.
But still.
Raised. Yeah, Cyrillic language. I understand, dude. Mm-hmm. You know.
I trust your vodka. It's, cool. Hey. It's what.
It's nothing.
How do you say Nastrovia?
Like, not. Yeah. I don't.
Yeah, you all good in my book. So,
is the thing,
I cannot trust a man as cool shades like that. You know, come on.
Always.
Hey guys,
bro,
I've only
way cooler shades than that. Can I put?
Yeah, I've only cooler than this.
I've got a Nintendo Switch too. Way cooler
retro,
than
you. Oh, welcome in. Sunglasses. Mr. Cairo, I can't re-invite you. There's no, you just have to hop back into the Discord chat and I will drag you in. There's no invites that happen with this. You just have to come back into the Discord. No, there's no invite, Mr. Cairo. It's in Discord, remember? Discord. So you come back into the general chat in Discord and I will drag you up to the private channel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So Discord general channel and I will drag you up. There's no invite involved.
No waiters out, please.
Right.
Pretty please.
I think Mr. Cairo is pretty... He's not a threat.
No, he's not. He He'll be just fine.
He was a fucking threat, man.
He was quite the amicable fellow.
He's very nice.
Yeah, yeah, I agree. That's
He's not a threat. No.
Dossie, you weren't there the other day. I saw a ween.
You did?
Yeah.
The first time ever.
Yeah, I should shower with dudes. Nothing.
It is a little shocking the first time, wouldn't you agree, ladies?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it's usually, you know, you don't.
It was an accident on his part. It was an accident on his part, I believe.
Oh, okay. They all say that.
Yeah.
Did you check lists, man?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
I was very mean to him.
Yeah.
Lady was there all too. Right. And then I, you know, said.
It's the nice ones you have to look out for. He is no threat. Him and I used to play Mortal Kombat 2. We did our finishers on one something. Okay.
What another?
Yeah. Oh, Fiscal used to.
He's just joking.
Play MK2 with. Oh, just joking around. Okay.
Yeah, he's just joking. So, Mr. Cairo, you just have to go back to the Discord, hop into like a chat channel, and I will drag you up. That's all you have to do, Mr. Cairo. Questions for you guys now that we're all here. Okay? We've got Bruca, Dossie, myself, Lady Winema, Wrinkly Beef, and Shytown. You're there.
Where's Shytown?
You're not in a voice channel. You are not in a voice channel, Mr. Cairo. Am I the only one? Wrinkly, do you see? You can drag him up too, I believe. If you see him.
He's not in there.
Oh, there he is. He's in games. I see him. Okay.
Thank you for lighting the fires. Push those up. There you go.
Yeah, I just don't have a camera.
I just didn't have it on my entire fucking monitor. So.
Okay. He's here now. Mr. Cairo's here.
I have too many channels.
Sorry about that.
That's okay. I do have a lot of channels. Okay, Mr. Cairo's here. Perfect. All right, guys, I would have, I know this is like a lot of people. So we've got Bruca, Dossie, myself, Lady Winema, the real Mr. Cairo, Wrinkly Beef, and Shytown DK. Since it is date night, though, I do want to have a little structure to this. I want to ask, like,
who's going to win?
Like, dates. What's an ideal first date for you guys?
Can I start?
Whoever thinks of something first, go ahead. Ideal.
My ideal date.
I think I answered this question before.
Let's everybody start out first.
Yeah, didn't I answer that question before? What's the perfect date for me?
I don't remember. Yeah, maybe
you did, but like English isn't your first language, so let's take a second and maybe.
Oh, do you want like me to speak in Spanish to understand better?
Please, no.
No, because we don't speak that.
Por favor, también habla español.
Okay. So let me answer first to that question. My perfect date is to invite my date to my house to cook dinner, to get some good wine, drink rosé, Chardonnay, and you know, to cook in front of her. And it's a win-win combination because, you know, we're at my place, we eat, you know, I do something for her, and, you know, what happens, it happens, right? We're at my place, so it's a win-win situation.
May I speak?
Yeah, sure, absolutely.
Sure. Sure, go ahead.
My first date, I don't know you. I'm not coming to your house.
Yeah, not a first date, Bruca. Nice try, but not a first date.
But I do like where you're going with that, but a first date.
Okay,
I love your venue, but even
if I say that I'm gonna cook the whole dinner and everything for you.
You could be a serial killer.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Listen. But you need to understand that first date comes after someone already meets you, right? So either you know each other from some other friends, or you met in a club before, right?
Maybe not. Before. No. Maybe could be a first date off of Tinder. Never met this person.
Okay. I don't do first Tinder dates at my house either. because I don't know if a girl is a psycho then, you know, how she's going to react. So, you know, I wouldn't do that either. So we're on the same page. About but I'm talking, yeah, I'm talking about if you met that person before. So, you know, you spoke before and then you invite her to, you know, to do something like that. You know, for a date like that, that's a totally different vibe, right? So right. She already spoke with you. So you already had some type of conversation before that.
Mutual friends, it's possible. Mutual friends, yes. Anything else, I say no. I don't know what these ladies say.
No, Dossie, I agree with you 100%. Like, yeah, if it's not through mutual friends and I haven't met you at another location, then no, I'm not coming to your house.
Yeah.
And even then, it's highly probable that I would not come to your house even on the legit first date.
Yeah. I usually go to the other ones.
Okay, I have a question for you.
Without even asking.
My question is, did you ever have a one night stand?
Every time.
Of course. Please.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
That's not a date.
Nope.
That's just physical exercise.
Now, when you say one night stand, you just met that person that day. You literally hook up and you never see them again. Like,
yeah, yes, but that's the same fucking thing. He brings you to your house, or I mean,
I know you're shaking
in the car or whatever. But usually it happens. You know, you bring your date to your house, right? That's one night stand. Right? Usually happens like that.
It's typically on. It would be on my terms. Everything would be in my favor on my terms. My turf.
So you bring him to your house instead?
I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, it happened. But
you know,
maybe hotel.
You know, maybe I'll just swear. But I've never the first date thing to use somebody like that. That's just not my vibe. You know, yes, I've done it. I regretted doing it. I'm like, you know what? That's just not me. And I stopped doing that as a young man. I'm like, no.
Because I don't say it was a date.
I'm empathic like that because I don't like being used. I don't like using people in that way. So that's why the Tinder stuff, that kind of, no.
Oh, yeah, no.
Why do you think anyone is used?
No, not for me. God bless you. I'm not throwing shade on nobody else. If that's how you want to get your groove on, go for it.
I personally I need more of a connection. Yeah. I probably, if I don't know that person, probably not even gonna enjoy it that much. Like, probably wouldn't even feel comfortable to climax with someone if I don't know them.
Did you have one night stand?
Yeah, you know, everyone's not saying done. That. You know,
take that.
Yeah, I'm not saying if you've done
it. I'm serious.
You know,
I'm dead serious.
Can't do that anymore.
No, I agree with her.
There's so many guys that would love to make you climax here. Please take it. You know,
and can you answer my question?
Yes, but I would like to get to know them before I do something like that. You know what I mean?
Okay,
I wouldn't be a one night stand.
Ask you, hey.
Okay, you so grow? that's your preferable way, but it doesn't have to be like that, right? And also, do you think that if you had one night stand with someone, it doesn't have to escalate to something more than that? If it happens on the first night, for example, it doesn't mean that it can escalate to something more than that?
No, it could. It absolutely could.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it could.
You know? I'm not saying practice of it. I'm saying I don't think anybody here can say it's never happened to them.
I agree with whoever just said that.
Yeah.
I agree with that as well.
Everybody loves asking the fucking chicks how they, you know, think about it, right? But no one ever asked the fucking dudes.
We want to know, Wrinkly. You tell us about it. I want to know. I want to know. You tell us.
No one ever fucking knows, man.
Well, this is your platform. This is your opportunity. We want to know.
Should I find some cigarettes and smoke them the fuck inside? Jesus Christ.
Oh, good Lord.
you want to be like me?
So much, Wrinkly. Come on now. You're safe.
No, not at all. No, you can.
You're safe. You can come. No, I'm kidding.
Acceptable.
We'll spoon you afterwards. You'll be all right. We'll spoon you.
It is fine. It is fine to like meet a chick on the internet, go buy her a few drinks, right?
Nobody said that. Then, where did I love this, but nobody said internet.
Yes, well, does have
like,
to be internet.
He means like dating apps, like type of stuff. Yeah.
Talking about Tinder.
Yeah.
Whatever the fuck you want to call them. Yeah, same thing.
Bumble. What do they call Bumble? Or...
Yeah.
This dude asked me.
Yeah, that's one of them. Yep.
This guy asked me a few years ago.
You meet up with them, you buy them a few fucking beers, and then they invite you back to their house. It's not rocket science. Half the time, you can bring your fucking dog.
That's probably your mom.
Yeah, it's not that hard. Do I like doing that? No, because it's not fulfilling. And I don't get anything out of it. And I never talk to them again.
But why don't you talk to them again?
It's possible to do. It's super easy. I don't feel good about it.
Those are like transactional dates.
Those are transactional dates. Dating, just go get your groove.
Have you ever lived with a chick, man? You gotta buy him everything.
Okay, guys, what is the actual date? What is the actual date for you?
Transactional? It means like you pay for everything.
No.
What is the actual date for you, guys?
For me, a date is...
Go there, act like you're on a fucking Twitch stream, and then like
hold on, Wrinkly.
They like Wait. Say, "Hey, can I see your wiener?" Okay. That's about it, man. You know,
I've never done like internet dating. Never. For me, it's you meet someone, you make a connection, you agree to like go somewhere, have a date, like a real date.
Yeah.
And you go to me, it's you go to possibly a shit pub. Where it's just you and her.
Yeah,
and
that's my go-to is a shit club. Yeah,
you just talk and you try to make a connection.
Okay, yeah. but my question is, does it have to be some certain limit that how much you need to know the person before you realize and you look at like that as a real date? Because
yes,
because
what is a date? Yeah.
Right. Yeah. No wrong answers. No right answers.
Yeah.
Let the women talk now, I think.
That's a question for your girls as well. What is the real date? Because you said, like, I wouldn't accept, you know, a guy to invite me to his house, you know?
As a first date?
Yeah, that's insane.
Usually a public place.
You can't do that here.
Yeah. Usually a public place. Doesn't have to be expensive, though. Doesn't have to be, like, a white tablecloth dinner or something. Could be a picnic in the park.
No.
Walk out. Some of them, I think an ideal date would be going from place to place, actually. So start off, I don't know, at a bar, like at a pub, on a patio or something.
Discovered my strat, actually.
Okay. First of all, guys, don't do picnics in the park, right? That's something that we do after.
They will
you know,
if they like the girl.
Not me. Maybe after a couple years.
They will.
Listen to me. We do that after 6 months, 1 year, like when we're together for a long time. I'll agree. But as a first date,
it's a repeat at that point.
You know, that's not something that we do. You know, I'm not gonna
first date. I want to see if you fucking meet me here. You know, I want to see if you're fucking, you know, not messing around. You know,
so that's your first date criteria, whether you turn up or not.
Yeah, that's fair. that's the first thing.
Fizzle
Reaction says that was his strat. You bastard. That was his strat upstream 25 minutes ago.
Coffee? Oh, no, dude. I'll never give a chick coffee, man. They get too rowdy. Royal. Too rowdy.
The number one criteria is that they show up. If you text me, see me in person afterwards, you're like, oh, no. Like, I completely forgot. Oh, no. Mm-mm.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, that you just know, shows it on the manners, period.
Right. Yeah,
manners are important.
As long as they show up, it's like 80% is done, right?
So no, 80%.
Define gun.
If they show up, they're 80% in like Flynn. No. Not quite.
I'm not saying you're wrong, but I want to know your reasoning behind that.
Reasoning behind that? Okay. Okay, I'm going to tell the reasoning behind that. Let's say, for example, that a girl accepts your date, right? So 80% that is that something's going to happen, right? So the only thing that you should worry about is not to fuck it up, you know, because even if you stay on 80%, something's going to happen, you know. She will like you, she will want to see you another time or whatever, right? So
on a good day, she'll even drive you back to her place.
I mean, yes, up, but yeah,
you can
I'm just saying, driving you back to her place. If a girl accepts your date, it's 80% done. Your only thing is not to fuck it up, right? So that's why I'm saying, you know, it works like that, you know, in the both ways. Yeah, I mean, you girls, you can tell me that. You're not going on a date with a guy that you're like, I don't really like him. He's like me. There's nothing special about him. So he has like 20% chance, right? No. You're not going to go on a date with a guy like that. You're going
I've given him less.
No.
I agree with Lady.
I don't know what to say.
There's no chance that you're not going on a date with a guy that you don't already give him some chance to win you over, right?
A chance is not 80%.
Yeah, no.
A first date is a chance. Yes, that is a chance. Bubbles, those odds seem off to me. Yes. I'm giving it like 10%.
Right.
Maybe, like, I don't know if I would give it 10%, but like probably more than a little more than 10%. Like
25. Yeah, I'd say about 25%.
About 25%. Yeah.
Yeah. If they're interested enough, 25%
that you will be successful from the first date.
Yes.
Yes.
Give him 25%.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that you're full of shit. I don't think it works that way at all.
It does.
I'm sorry. I don't think it does.
So, Bruca, with your past experiences, why would you settle
with someone that you give only 25% chance?
Bruca, with your past experiences, are you trying to tell us that you get it in 80% of the time with first dates?
Yes, because I only go on the dates with the girls that I really, really like and find something special about them.
Even if you really like them, that doesn't mean they feel the same, though, and they're going to be give it up.
No. I'm talking about me. How I see that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, from your perspective,
I'm talking about from my perspective.
America, what can I say? You know,
first date is sex. Like, that's
is that what he's saying?
You're looking for. That's not what I look for.
Exactly.
Sex. You
seem to be talking about, like, you know, sealing the deal, like first date, 80%, this, that, and the other.
It doesn't have to be just physical appearance, but it has to be everything that I'm attracted to. So I have reason why to see that girl, you know, for the second time or third time, or, you know.
Well, that's fair, yeah.
So
most of the time there isn't chemistry. Bubbles, you're right. Bubbles. Also, Bubbles, how did that date go? Did you ask her out for a second date? You said there was chemistry. I'm fucking curious. Tell me, Bubbles. How did the second
date
go?
Bubbles did a date?
Yeah, and it went well. And I want to know, was there a second date? Did it go as well? Let us know. Most women I date have a 3-date rule. I guess I am I date tighter women. Yeah, like normally, I just go out on a first date to feel that person out.
Mm-hmm.
And not much gets accomplished on that date except for getting to know each other. Seeing if I want to go on a second date. Second date, I get a little more loose for sure. You know, third date. Yeah. And if you go on, let's say 5 dates with a girl and nothing happens, cut your losses. Cut your losses because probably nothing will happen.
Okay, Anne, but my question, do you need just 25%? To like the guy in order to get on a second date with him, on the first date with him.
Sorry, there's variables. Very
do you need only 25% in order to get on the first date with a guy? Just 25%.
Yeah.
Because that's what you told me.
I would say about just 25%. Yeah.
How many is that like... in Balkans?
Yeah.
I mean, it's the same. It's the same. We don't have like different measures, but.
Like, I would be willing to give the guy a chance for a first date if I kind of like him about 25%. You know what I mean? Like, a quarter. You know, I'm like, okay, you know, I might not be smitten over the guy. I would give him a chance if I liked him about 25%. If I only liked the guy 10%, I probably wouldn't even give him a chance. You know, it's different. It's hard to say. I'm generalizing, right? But
I mean,
they're having an off day.
No, I mean, there can be only two reasons why you're thinking like that. Either, like, you have really high expectations from the guys, and that's why would you settle, you know, for only 25%, or you have, like, really, really low expectations, so that's why you can settle with that.
Fragment, welcome in. Okay. Welcome in, Fragment. I have pretty high expectations, I think.
Here's a better...
Yes, you must.
Here's a better question.
Oh, no, Bubbles. Yeah.
Can I tell you something? If I like the girl 25%, there's no chance in this world I'm gonna go on a date with her.
Long distance, maybe, Bubbles.
25% is a lot for me, man.
25%.
All I'm saying is, if you're on a date with somebody,
yeah,
and you're less than 50% convinced that they are worthy of a second date, then just cut it off, move on, you know.
Yeah.
Really.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're looking for those instant connections.
I don't know. I think we have different...
We do. We definitely have different things. Different criteria.
Right.
Well, maybe you want to say between dating...
Everyone has different criteria.
And dating to find somebody who's compatible.
Yeah.
But sometimes you can just go on a date because, hey, this is a fun person. I wouldn't trust them as far as... I wouldn't have that person in my house, but hey, they're great to be around. Like
there you go.
Everybody hey, Shia, I love that you said
everybody
that.
Everybody has a cousin that they they know that they phone, but you know,
I ain't dating my fucking cousins. Time,
you're gonna have to make that phone call. Like,
oh my
I'm
god,
dead, somebody!
I ain't dating no fucking cousins. I know I'm a fucking hick,
you be with,
but like,
but you better have bail money.
Dude, hey now.
Okay. I don't know, okay. Lady. I'm way more inbred than you are. Don't worry about it. All right.
Okay. I have a question for Zakaria. Would you go on a date with a guy just because you want to have like fun? You think you wanna, you know, like a hangout?
No.
Yeah, but
like
that would probably be clearly established.
Mm-hmm. And do you think if you establish that to a guy, and call him, like, there can't be anything, we could only be friends, that he would go on a date with you after that?
Oh, absolutely. Because men always think that there's a chance. Always. You can tell them, forget about it. Forget about it. Forget about it. They're always like, she didn't tell me to fuck off and die. So
not yet.
So we are.
Okay, that's true. You know, hope is always there, but yeah. I mean, I would never go on a date under that circumstances, but yeah, I understand what you're saying.
I wouldn't call it a date. I would say, yeah, let's go hang out. I'm gonna take care of my own. What I drink is mine. I will pay
instead of
my
hug,
own way.
We do.
I likely would be like,
yeah, the best. That's rare.
Yeah, that's what you do.
Yeah. Okay, but why
what
do you
I do
think,
to like most chicks I hang out
okay,
with?
Okay, but why do you think a guy like me that have like very close circle of friends? I have like 3-4 friends, that best friends, and they're all guys. Would I need like a girlfriend, like a girl that I'm gonna hang out and, you know, be friend with? Why do you think I would need that?
For perspective.
Yeah.
Or at least like experience in it. Yeah, I agree with that.
Mm-hmm.
Experience.
Why? Yeah, I think it's good to
fucking
have
crazy man.
Yeah, they are. You can only handle so many
and, like,
of them.
It,
so
it
much
teaches
of them.
You a lot of things. I feel like living with them, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Sharing bills, sharing like everything. No.
Are you talking about as a girlfriend, or are you talking about just a friend?
No, as a man, having a girlfriend. So I feel like the ultimate question we're like reaching here is, you know, it's like what's the next step, right?
What's like
moving in together, sharing bills, getting a house together, all of that, right? All of you have done this. I can't speak for you. Well, I especially cannot speak for you, Anne. I know I can speak for you, Dossie, and I know I can speak with for you, lady.
That's a little bit past the first date, like, surely.
Yeah, that's a lot of. I don't know what that word means.
Hold on. Well, to be honest, when it comes to that, I have never experienced sharing bills. I've always paid all the bills.
Oh, that's great. Oh, it really is.
But you understand the process of that, though, right?
Yeah.
The process of getting fucked over? Yeah, totally.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's no way. There's no way I would.
That's my last experience, like living with a woman.
There's no freaking way. If somebody that I'm
I also
with,
had to. When her dad was fucking rich. So I'm not super excited to like live with a woman again, honestly. I'm really not.
That's why I think I might have a skewed perspective on your questions, Bruca, because everything that you've said so far about, you know, from a guy's perspective is not anything that I've ever experienced. It's been any guy that was trying to ask me out or anything, it was kind of just like, oh, okay, let's give it a go. Maybe I fully liked him. It was just let's see what happens. And that a good bit of my dates never went past the first date just because they expected so much more on the first date.
Same.
That wasn't the thing. Right.
Yeah, that's a good thing. That's self-preservation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, no, please, that's just living, goddamn.
You know, because as fast as you can dump everything on me, you leave just as fast.
Okay, so you were never on a date that you had higher expectations from it than a guy?
There has been one, yes.
Me?
One specifically.
Okay. Okay, and what happened?
Obviously nothing.
Obviously nothing, man.
Yeah, nothing. Like, I actually had really high expectations of me and him. We have met before. I thought we had a good repertoire, like it was good. And then all of a sudden, I was like, okay, maybe this could be more. Nope. Because the way that the date was set up was...
And how many times did he fucking ignore you?
About 90% of the time.
What are you talking about, ignore? Where did we go from that to ignore?
On the date itself, I was ignored because I found out later it wasn't a date just to get to know me. It was a date that he was using me for.
That makes sense.
He was using me to get back at somebody or try to make someone jealous, something like that. So
yes, that
I
makes
had
sense
higher,
because I had only, expectations only, reason, only reason why a guy would go on a date with a girl that he doesn't actually like is because he is trying to make some other girl jealous.
Yeah.
That's not the only reason.
Like, up until that point, everyone in our friend group was like, okay, y'all would make a good couple. Y'all seem to like each other because we would hang out, you know, if we were in a group setting. Me and him would hang out most of the time. Like, if we were, like, in, like, doing, like, team games or something, me and him would be paired up. Like, we had a really good vibe.
Team games IRL?
Yeah, as in, like, we go bowling and we team up and we'd be, like, hanging out together.
I'd fucking crush you in bowling.
But we'll see. Anyway, and that everything seemed good until the actual date. And then it kind of just fell apart. And I was like, I was expecting more because of what previously was done. Like,
okay, more, so he was actually
after the third time, right, lady? After like the third time, you told him to go kick rocks, right?
Oh no, that's I just entertain him just because it's funny now. like,
okay. So I was talking was about somebody else. Then, I'm sorry.
No, no, it wasn't him. No. I never met that one. I have never met that one in person. He has stood me up so many times. I've never met that one in person.
Well, what? Who's this?
Oh, it's that's a long long story. That's a long, long story.
Okay. Oh, okay. This
watch her stream. She'll tell you about it. You know.
I want to hear Cairo's perspective.
Yeah.
Of what?
Get laid, brother.
My perspective is always
this dirty mess that we apparently have.
I mean, my perspective is that, I mean, I don't do dating like online. I'm too old for that shit. I really am.
No.
Are you doing any dating at all?
Yeah, but it's mostly like work related. And when it goes wrong, it makes work really, really awkward.
The thing with me is
I'm
everybody shut the fuck up.
What people call on the spectrum, I'm terrible in a social situation.
Environment?
Yeah. If I know people, I'm great. If I don't know people, I'm not great. But I'm great in a one-on-one situation. So I always try to, if I meet someone, however, online, or well, maybe not online, but work, or maybe a friend of a friend, I'm great at that first date. After that, not so great maybe. But that's what it's about to be. It's a totally different thing. I mean, Bumble and Match.com and all this shit, just hooking up like random people online.
Right.
I can't do that shit.
Why do you think that's different than this, what we're doing right
now?
This is it right now. Why do you think this is different than any other social network?
It's not different because people are just never met.
You just like a couple of words online and you just hook up. That's just bizarre.
Kind of rules, man. You should try.
Yeah. I mean, it's one step away from prostitution.
Yeah. Don't you? It's like 2 to 3 steps away from it. Right?
That's not much.
Not really.
Yeah.
But have you been married before, Cairo?
Not if you pay the app. No. Then it's not prostitution, right?
No. Obviously, people that go on Bimble, Tinder, and
that's America, baby. That's capitalism, dog.
Like that, they want to fuck, right?
Dossie, you shake your head. I understand your frustration with this. However,
it's unacceptable.
Why?
It's not unacceptable. It's just different.
They like me. So
there's
why?
Okay, because it's a different, I don't know, lady. It's a different standards.
Yes.
Different expectations.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to say
I'm not throwing shade on you, Wrinkly. I'm just saying
I think it's valid. I think that is what Wrinkly does is very common.
Very common
in today's day and age, right? It's not for everyone, just like as the real Mr. Cairo just mentioned. Fragment 37, who's about the same age as Mr. Cairo, maybe a little bit younger. I just want to connect them a little bit. Just want to keep them so it's interactive. Standing someone up, you get 2 chances. Fragment says, I'm not too old to date online, but the women I get paired up with are too old for me. So maybe that's the problem.
That's an attitude problem.
When you can choose the age of your...
I mean, technically,
you choose the range of age. So how? Tell me how.
Easy. I can tell you this. Easy.
You set the fucking age to like
people,
what
people lie. People lie about their age. Is that it?
Yeah, there's that, and there's also the fact of you have people that when if you see their profile pic or whatever, that they're
also smoking cigarettes inside is an option, but
some of their stuff is immediate red flags. So I'm not going to pick
take a
the
chick
red
back
flags.
To your place, dude, and like. Your place smells like cigarettes.
And
you're
so, with the apps,
laid.
Majority of the apps.
Hey, Rico, shut the fuck easy. Up. Let the girl talk. Okay. Continue, please.
That with these apps, you can choose the range and you can choose the distance. But if you go through all the options that are available to you within those two, it will actually say, hey, we're going outside your range. Here you go.
Correct.
So that has happened. That happens to me 9 times out of 10 because the most people around here, I'm not dating a meth head.
Okay.
Well, not with that attitude here now.
That makes sense.
Not with that attitude. Skiz says y'all are fascinating. Warhan says sex always comes with a price. Pete says, I agree. I would never date anyone I work
Skiz,
with.
I know you get laid, bro. Probably. Like, come on. You gotta fucking weigh in on this.
I agree, would never date anyone I work with. I've seen, it's awkward. Couples fighting at work, no thanks. Fragment, I don't want young women. I just don't want women in their 50s when I'm more like in my 40s mentally and physically. Yeah, but Fragment, you could change the range so you can search for women in their 40s. If you're in your 50s.
Can I get women in my 50s? Send them my way,
please. What's wrong with women in their 50s? My God. You know,
it's a preference. There's nothing wrong with women in their 50s, but I guess Fragment has a preference. He mentally is more in his 40s and he wants to date women in their 40s, which is fair, right?
It's a preference because, you know, guys, when we are younger as guys, I'm pretty sure that I can talk for all of us. When we are younger, we're always craving for the older girls, like the MILFs, right?
Yeah.
That we love can, them. You know, that
fucking,
can teach
I
us something MILFs, or something, right? And there is some certain age that we just trigger to the, you know, younger ones, that when we prefer the younger ones. So,
how old are you, if you don't mind me asking, Ruka?
Well, then again.
I mean, I'm 36.
36?
Yeah.
You look like 50, so... You could probably do
pretty
well.
Okay.
Bro, I'm beat
now,
up. And
not
understand.
In a bad way, dude.
No, I'm beat
okay,
up.
Okay, now I understand where you're at. Because honestly,
it's not in a bad
honestly,
way.
Honestly, Serbia, I thought you
no,
were
No, it was in a bad way, motherfucker.
Okay, so. I thought he was in his 40s, too. That's, but I think it's just he's much more mature. Because he's from another country, like, you know...
Yeah, because I thought you were like 42, 40, somewhere
yeah,
like that.
Yeah,
so.
I thought you
no
were in your
shame.
40s as well.
Anything. We're just from, you know, opposite
Okay, people, don't forget that I survived 2 wars and I survived 2 divorces. So
you didn't fight in either of them, though. So let's
Had the wars on the inside and the outside.
Well, Broker, I've survived a divorce.
Let's make that distinction, too. So did all of us, man.
Yeah, makes a difference. So,
what'd you say, lady?
I survived a divorce, too.
No, he said wars.
And 2 divorces.
I said wars and
divorces. No, he said 2 divorces.
None of that matters. None of that matters.
No, it matters for experience, right?
Preferences. Everyone's got their own things that they like to do.
No, but I like people that speak from their own experience, right? So it's not that you're talking just because you read the Reddit post, right? As somebody else.
I read the Bible.
Okay, you read the Bible, but but if you're speaking from your own experience, right? So that matters to me.
Mm-hmm.
It's very much experience, because then what you have to say is valid.
Yeah, yes. And that's why I also respect a lot your opinion as well, as you could hear from all the talk and everything. I always ask you about your opinion. What do you think about the topics that we talk about?
It's lot different, man. It's a lot different.
I just felt a little tingle of Riz. That just hit me there. One, two, buckle my shoe.
That crushed.
It's
yeah, yeah, motherfucking 3-4.
You okay? Yeah. And you just had me check the chat and see if Panda was here. Hold up.
I'm not even looking at chat. Dude, my hands
no,
are
Rook,
off.
No, Rook, I just heard a little riz.
My hands are off right now.
Yeah, yeah, it was.
No
it
hands was. On deck right here.
And
yeah,
if there's
you can do whatever you want.
There's things like if I told you the divorces that I have had, there'd be mad judgment.
Mm-hmm.
Mad judgment.
Yeah, yeah.
Because yeah, do you care about? Do you care?
Do you care about the judgment?
Do you care about the judgment?
Probably.
Not really.
But it might play into the whole dating thing, though.
Little bit.
Oh, hell yes it would. But then they don't know why you woke up and you said, uh-uh, this is not working.
Darcy? Yeah. Can I say something?
Go.
So, the favorite fucking thing of mine you've ever said? I asked about certain firearms, and he told me.
Oh, yep. Yeah.
Locked,
I live by
locked
that.
And ready to rock, dude. Every fucking
How about
room in
I
my
have
house.
A SIG. You show your SIG to your friends, and you show your Glock.
Frank Sauer and your Eddie Bauer. That's Panda's line.
Okay, I just
he was
a
Marine,
Dawson
though,
a
so
more.
he carried a SIG PP26. Pete.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, sorry. You have more than one, hey. But then there's one that you always have. Always.
And you also believe in ghosts, which is crazy. I don't even believe in ghosts yet.
Well,
oh, okay.
Because I've never seen one.
A lot of people don't see them.
Yeah, that's.
But my
I haven't
point,
seen one yet, but I do. Like I believe they can exist.
They yeah. do exist.
Well,
but my point I mean, is there would be so much judgment, but then nobody knows exactly what triggered whatever it was. Maybe somebody
and
was...
And they never will. And they never will. You can't expect people to know that your story and how you felt in some certain moments and what happened to you, right?
Exactly. Because
so
I don't
can't,
tell
they can't judge. They can't judge about it.
Right. Because you don't carry your trash out for everybody to see.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
because really for anybody who something happened to because they trusted the wrong person or whatever, do you know how dumb you feel?
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to share that shit. You're just going to walk away with your head up. That's it.
I would I would tell everybody
you know,
about
you
it.
Know,
this
will sound funny. For me, it's easier to share and to talk about some things with you guys that I never met and I will never meet in my life.
100%.
And honestly, I don't really care about you, right? So the thing is that I can talk about you about those topics with you guys, but I can't talk with the people that are around me.
Yeah.
Don't be insulted.
Because
it's a safe space here, bro. It is. It's yeah. a safe space.
I just mean that it's always been very easy to say things to people you don't really know than to people you do know.
Absolutely. Because people that you know will judge
exactly.
you and you're going to be around them. Right?
You might not never see me again.
And you have to deal with that. And yeah. I don't have to deal with any of you guys, right?
Right.
Oh, it's a different thing.
The only teenagers I've had to ban from my Twitch chat were dudes. And that's because they posted like scat porn and shit.
Yeah,
well,
because
that,
they're
Discord
there's
no it, man.
Yeah, because
well,
there are no girls there coming to your channel.
You
What's
have to
that?
Be careful when you're in a when you're like I have people that I trust because they're your ride or die, and you can tell pretty quick.
Yeah,
yeah,
I mean, it's
facts.
If you're an adult, you understand this kind of shit. You know what I mean?
Are you?
But what I'm saying
no.
is,
am I? No, I'm a young man. Man,
it's easier yeah. to speak on here because how are you going to hold that against me?
Exactly.
How are you going to? How are we going to build a trustful relationship? And then one day you're going to say, Oh, really? Well, you know what? That time at band camp when you fell in the hole and you cried.
W reference.
You're I remember that. Age. Yeah.
That one time at band camp.
Band camp.
I'm saying.
Was it something about like a clarinet?
You have to be very, very,
flute.
Very careful flute. Because it is.
I was a trombone.
Always used against. Right. You.
I know.
Always.
Exactly.
Okay, so now you see why I value your opinion so much, because you're talking from your own experience, right?
Tuba.
That's why I like you.
I'm just saying that in my experience, which may or may not be vast, that
pretty vast.
I'm pretty sure you have experience.
At some point, something
I don't
want
to ever talk for Dossie, but
to show.
She knows what's
up. To show what you what they may interpret as your weakness.
Yeah, facts
and
were.
Their weakness tries to expose yours. It's really shitty.
Yeah.
So that's why
the fucking bad guys.
The worst part of betrayal is it never comes from an enemy.
Never.
No. Yeah, it comes from the closest friends. Yes, but I'm also
depends.
type of friend that if I'm betrayed by the closest people, you better watch your back after that.
Also facts.
Yeah, I wouldn't fucking trust you farther than I could throw you, and you look pretty thick, boy.
To be honest, in that situation, it's not me you got to worry about. It's the redhead in my house.
Mm-hmm. That's a dog.
They always crazy.
That is not.
Or is that your mom?
This is her
That's
mom.
My mom.
Ah, dang.
However, like, I'm just saying.
She can shoot.
You know, the thing is, the reason why I don't talk about private things with my my friends that I want to be close with is because I'm protecting them. Because
you live
them.
In an ex-communist country, probably.
No, I'm trying to protect them.
That's not
why.
That's not why.
Them from me and not me from them.
Chill, it's more about a masculine thing. The way males are just
I don't want to give them a reason to jeopardize our friendship. You understand?
That's fair.
Yeah,
so I'm trying to, you know, protect, you know, them from that.
Are you autistic or something? Or like why do you have
no
it's on still?
Women, how you got a black women. Eye? Go
you
on.
Can take your sunglasses off, man.
No,
nobody's taking their sunglasses off. We all have secrets.
Yeah.
Yep.
Fair. Well, at least you're outside, Dosie.
However, what I'm saying is like I'm just saying you don't want to expose yourself because of probably past wounds. So you don't expose yourself. And then once you do, you go, oh, shit. There it is.
In my state, we call that an "oops, oops, Bobby Stoops." But
tell me when that happens that you got betrayed by your close friend, do you blame them or you blame yourself for giving them opportunity to that to happen?
Well,
I've never been crossed by one of my best friends.
How do you look on that?
Second time on me.
Either.
Okay,
I've only been betrayed by myself.
So fool me once, don't fool me twice, right?
Right.
That's
But fool me once, shame on you.
I've been lucky,
fool me twice, shame on me.
So believe me, I'm carrying around a lot of shame.
Nobody's ever fucked me over.
Because I really... The human part of you always wants to err to trust. Always, no matter what you want to believe, you do.
Correct.
That's why in the CIA and in things like that, they have to switch up because we are close. And I want to believe you. I want to believe Anne. I want to believe Lady. And I do.
Yeah, because you feel better than that, you know, thinking like that you can trust people, right? You feel better.
That's why
we were fucking trained to, and we still fucked
up. In my nature, it's not like that at all.
Because What, Cryo? Cairo?
I just, that's what relationships are about. You get to that point where you expose yourself and you have to expose vulnerability to the person that you're with.
Yes.
There's three people in this chat that I've told stuff to, and I trust them with everything. And will I ever meet them? I don't know, but I trust them 100%.
That's me, Ann, and Dossie.
I mean, honestly, you know, I think it's really stupid thing to
I'm a steel trend,
on the, on the internet. So,
what do you think is stupid? I don't understand. What?
To trust people on the internet if you want to be close to them, right?
Yeah, from the Balkans, maybe. But like, dude, try the internet in America. It fucking rules.
Rules
mean
I wouldn't agree with that.
It's nice. It kicks ass. It is fast. You can get like 1,000. Let's call it 1,000, right?
Megabytes. You're a pure example of that, right?
I'm not going to show you my internet bill, but yeah, I have gig speed internet. Yeah.
Well, if you're talking about
I don't think you get it, 87 bucks a month.
It's not that
big. I don't think you get it what we're talking about here, so.
I don't. You know. I don't get it because I live in fucking Nebraska, dude.
No,
yeah.
Like I don't live in like fucking ex Eastern Bloc fucking bullshit, dude. I just don't.
Doesn't mean humanity is not the thing. That doesn't mean humanity is not the thing.
Right.
And
I just don't live.
Anne and I have never met, and I can tell you that if I called Anne in the middle of the night and I needed help, she would find help for me. She couldn't come and help me, but
she would at least answer though.
I'm 100% sure in that.
She would at least fucking answer though.
I would.
No, I'm 100% sure.
And I would feel terribly guilty or something if I couldn't help. If someone asked for help and like came to me and I couldn't help, it would.
First of all, don't ever fucking call Anne for help.
No,
she's not going to come help you.
First of all, don't ever ask Anne for help because she can't.
If I texted Anne for help, she'd be like, dang.
There's a difference. You wouldn't even open the text message.
I would ask my
mom,
honestly, because she loves
you. But you would answer a call from her, so that's a huge difference.
There's that one
even
guy.
Even if she didn't answer right away.
Yeah.
Lady Wenmina is the same. I know Lady. Okay. So even if you didn't see that text for 6 hours, I know they would follow up and they would follow the chain as far as they could, which they likely would follow it all the way.
Probably about like the time I would be getting out of jail, actually.
That's why you're not on the call list.
Yeah.
Not that we don't love you. But there's just people that you know that would follow up.
Oh, no, I know.
That's why in certain situations, Wrinkly's the first one I'm going to call.
Yeah.
Isn't that the entire thing, though?
I know a lot of people across the country.
Just think,
money doesn't work the fucking same here in Nebraska, man, that it could in Alabama or fucking Ontario or South Dakota, man.
Really?
Yeah.
Do all the guys in Nebraska talk that much like you?
No.
Not Cairo. Really.
Cairo's trying to speak.
Sorry.
Yeah.
I just think you, Wrinkly, are the sort of epitome of the modern age. You're the young guy, you're the don't care about anything, you just hook ups like left, right, and center. There's no connections.
Yeah, I got a big ass wiener. What else?
No, I'm good. I'm done.
I'm hoping that this is just he's just
a bad thing. Sorry, I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I'm just saying it's a a symptom of the modern age. To me. I mean, I'm an old guy, you know? I was there.
How old are you? Like 40?
No, it's not 48. A symptom of the old age. We, 48? Guys, we, all, nice. We were always...
Really?
Wow, Bruca, you're 30... What are you, 35? Six. I thought you were...
36.
Yeah.
And you're 48.
Oh, you want to say that?
You know?
You want to say that wait. Look way older?
Sure.
Wait.
Says a nice quote. Wait, be slow to fall into friendship, but when thou art in, continue firm and constant. Socrates.
Socrates is one of my favorite philosophers.
What is speaks to loyalty? It's a rarity on how amazing it is to experience it with someone. I agree, Skiz.
I would die for my country and my mom and my dad and my brothers. That's about it.
Okay. Anyway, pull me up, okay? I'm sorry. Y'all left me at three station stops behind.
Okay, well, come on.
Go ahead.
The train's leaving.
Yeah. Train done left.
I thought I was
Wrinkly.
I was on the train.
I love Wrinkly like he's like one of those sons that you got to love through they mess. That's it. You know, he'll get I'm not worried about that. Wrinkly will get there. He's still young. He still got puppy in him. That's fine.
He's calling me a puppy.
you got the puppy still in this one.
I think Wrinkly has a very good heart. I think he's fronting, and I think that he hasn't had his ass kicked enough.
You want to bet? I'm a big tough guy.
Gubby says, I honestly believe Wrinkly would go to the end of the earth for his friends he has online or IRL. Yeah,
ask all of them.
Yeah, he would. Wrinkly is a good friend. He knows how to be
a very good person.
A very loyal good friend. Yes.
Now, I'm not a good person, but I'll die for all my friends.
Yeah.
Humility.
You can ask all of them.
Humility comes from getting your ass whooped.
Yeah, I've got that plenty of times.
Yeah.
That's why my brain.
I think Wrinkly is a great guy, but I would get his ass whooped for sure one time, just so he learns some things. You know.
Respect.
I'm not talking about physically.
Yeah,
either.
I'll
I'm
fucking ruin
about,
you.
Respectfully. I respect that, though. I do respect that.
I will
that.
Respectfully ruin you. No.
Respectfully, yeah. I don't smoke
I'm
cigarettes.
About
so
age.
I'll gas you in fucking the first round, buddy. And that's okay. I understand your concern, and that's fine. But
Snazzy says, Wovwoo Wrinkly. Wovwoo Wrinkles.
Yes.
I guess.
Yes, we do love you. I'm just saying that there's some. I think that Wrinkly, this is a little bit of posturing because.
Oh, jeez. Wrinkly is not a trained fighter.
If you got Wrinkly and you were speaking to him for real, like if I had him here.
Yeah, we're just talking crap.
I don't think this would be the guy I'd be talking to.
Correct.
All I meant from what I said.
I agree.
We're a different generation.
What, Kyra?
Did somebody say genders?
No, they did not. No.
I'm pretty sure that.
What did you say, Kyra?
I just said that we're different generations.
Ah.
Yes.
I remember when nobody had a cell phone. Nobody. They did not exist. I remember when the internet.
Yeah, guess what else we got these days? A fucking gun, dude.
Ephemeral thing.
Yeah, nobody's beating me. I'm sorry for, you know.
Wait, I need to hear Cairo. Go ahead.
I just mean that we're very different. And it's fine. It's great. That's what the internet is about. That's what the world's about. Everyone's different, and yet we accept each other for what we are.
Baby.
I know that's very generic, but you know.
Well,
no, we're not.
It's not that generic, man. That's a fair point.
We're not here to agree with each other. We're not here to agree with each other, and we can respect each other, but we don't have to agree. And absolutely, we don't have to love each other.
We have to agree with it.
That was Sasha.
If I think that you're a piece of shit, I'm going to tell you in your face that you're a piece of shit. And I would tell you even if you met in, face to face, that doesn't make any difference, You know, we're here, to be honest, and we can have our differences, but we can also say our opinion about each other, right? We don't have to be shy from it, right? So if I don't like someone, or if sure. Anne doesn't like me and the way I'm speaking, she has all the rights in this world, to kick me from this chat,
She has the button. Call.
Yeah, I think it's better for all of us not to fight ever, Honestly.
No. I think it's better that we don't agree with.
If we did need to, I would win.
We're not
more trained. And stuff,
but we're not fighting.
I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Don't wear a fucking discounted Nike shirt to the fight, because I'll rip it off of you.
Man,
I don't know what that means. What does that mean?
Listen, here's the thing. I don't want a bunch of yes ma'ams in my channel.
I would like to see your pretty face, and then you tell me that face to face, and I'll. Yeah, and
I don't know how to say that. I don't know what language you talk, man.
I would kiss your mouth.
I don't know what you speak. I would kiss you on the mouth too, man.
Yeah. Yeah. So
after I beat you in a wrestling match, yeah, I would totally kiss you on the mouth.
Oh yeah, we can wrestle. Definitely.
Definitely.
See, that's where it goes south.
Yeah.
That's where it goes south, because we were having an intellectual conversation.
We were, and that's what I was trying to get at. Let me rein us in here. Let's hone us in. I don't want a bunch of yes ma'ams. And this, you're amazing, and that's fucking boring. I'm going to be honest, guys. I want everyone to have
a
difference. I want everyone to have a difference of opinions. We can intellectually have a conversation and be different and embrace each other's differences and not get argumentative and get in the mood to fight just because we have a difference of opinions.
Now,
it's
wrestling ain't fight.
You're right. Wrestling is structured fighting, but it's fighting.
We certainly shouldn't be sort of.
And I'm better at it.
Talking shit about ephemeral shit like Nike t-shirts and.
I don't care from
it has nothing to do with anything. Welcome back, Fragment.
Different place to me.
I have no idea where this is going. We were just looking at Sasha. She is a Pyrenees, Great Pyrenees.
So you're saying I shouldn't show my guns, man?
No, don't show. Only if this is the guns you can show. Show me these.
What is that? Walther PDP? They just released that one.
Show these guns.
I don't want to.
That's the only guns you can show. That's it.
Shut up.
Let's have Anne.
Yeah.
Give a question.
Yeah. Okay, so
maybe the gentleman.
I posed one question and it was like, where would you go on a first date?
How rocking are all of these tits?
I don't know, such a long time ago.
The best.
Yeah.
It's like an ideal first
date. I don't think I am.
What about?
Wait a minute, I don't think I am.
Oh, please tell me, Shy.
Thank you. As far as the first date, it really depends upon the person that I'm with, okay? In essence, if I met you for the first time in a Home Depot, okay, then I'm pretty sure you're not really interested in frilly things, not necessarily, okay? So I'll probably do something more structured towards that. If I met you in a Macy's, well, I'm pretty sure, if I take you to a Habitat for Humanity project, you probably say no. So it really depends upon how I meet you, okay? And what your reaction
is. No, that sounds terrible because you're assuming from those things.
It's not your turn. Shut up.
That doesn't have to be true at all.
See, that's what the dating part comes in. Okay, to find out. Okay, exactly. What are the things that make you tick? Okay, but I'm not going to.
Motherfuck doesn't even know what the fuck Home Depot is, man.
I know where Home Depot is. Trust me.
Wrinkly,
I know what Home Depot is. I know what Target is. I know what Walmart it is. So chill.
Never been there though. So maybe you chill. Okay.
But hold up. Go back.
Let me finish.
Let's go back.
Shy. And so that's, you know, you go on the first date, and I would probably want to be in a setting where I could actually pay attention to you, not be overly distracted. Taking a first date to a movie is a terrible idea.
Yes.
Do not do that.
Absolutely. Not because you don't have a chance to speak with a person to find out who they are. So why the fuck would you take a date on a movie on a first date? I mean, that's a fucking terrible idea. Simple as that.
Exactly. Exactly, or to any, I mean, I'm
not the reason,
you
but
may take them to a baseball game because baseball, it has such
baseball
long periods of nothing happening.
You can talk to them. Yeah,
and chicks hate baseball.
Football
dude.
Game, I would not take
no,
to
you
a football
got
game.
All the opportunity,
sorry, you know,
to fucking hang out with them and explain to them why baseball rules, right?
Yeah. You know, and so do something that you know that the person that you're going to go out with will have some enjoyment.
Dude, tell me a fucking chick that.
Now, if that
likes
person,
baseball,
hey,
dude, she probably works for the CIA.
Yeah, okay. If she says, hey, let's go to a shooting range. I never shot a gun in my life. I'm not opposed to it.
Probably, already
I'm
came.
Like, okay, that's tight.
I don't think they would do that.
I would definitely be
shy. Here's the thing.
I would be scared if a chick said that.
Why would you?
Actually,
that explains so much.
If a chick,
I think Lady Wymina and I can all agree that we are, just because you met me in a Macy's, that doesn't mean anything. Just because you met me in a Home Depot or a Menards or anything, that means nothing.
Yeah.
Because
Thank you.
Anybody with any
guns,
let's say aging in the fine barrel of whiskey or wine, would know that there are so many facets to an intelligent woman that what you just saw is nothing.
Look at Dossie now. She just built the structure she's sitting in, right? Like, mm-hmm. People were like, oh, is this a real housewife that's sitting in front of us? And she's so bougie. Oh my, you look like a millionaire. Like, this is what comments she was getting today on stream. And yet, she can get down and dirty, like, build structures. She can do it all, right? Multifaceted.
She's all right.
Comes with age, maybe. But people are chameleons.
Can I say, Dossie, I would never say a word to you if I were to, like, walk by you in real life. Never.
Probably wise to
because she would destroy you. That's why.
Why?
Because you would be scared to approach her.
Is that why?
That could be
a reason, dude. I won't lie.
But I make it that way because I make myself unapproachable on so many levels. Because
of course,
I would like to say a funny comment to you or something. That's about it.
What would you do?
Make a funny comment or something, depending on like what you're looking at, whatever. But I don't talk to people like in that way.
Well,
let's say we're in Home Depot. I've usually got some pretty fucking good firepower on me, you know? I don't
So does every other.
I'm not walking around starting shit with anybody. I mean, I don't go there to start.
I mean, where they're at is not the point of the issue.
Yeah.
What the issue is?
I'm not asking about the issue.
This is my issue. Is that even if someone seems not approachable, you still speak to them. You still say hello. You still present yourself. Hey, how you doing? And if they respond, if they don't respond, I will respond.
I will absolutely respond. I'm great. How are you?
But my mind works, I usually have a good barometer, I guess, for people who are also like carrying, you know, deadly firearms, right?
No, you don't. I guarantee you don't.
Yeah. Okay. So, can I ask how many people else have been
out of jail with a gun, or who's
Yeah. Okay. I'm the only one who's done all of that, been in shootouts and everything. That's fine. Don't even need to worry about that.
That doesn't have anything to do with approaching and using manners and saying good afternoon. It's just pleasantries. It's just manners.
Being a normal breeding person. Yeah.
Absolutely. I'm gonna tell you one thing. Anne, for example, she doesn't look when you look at her like, you know, when she has like straight face, you know, and look. She doesn't look like a very approachable person, right? That doesn't mean that she's super fucking hot. Yeah, but that also doesn't mean that she's gonna be, you know, she's gonna fuck you, you know, off just because you approach her. She's probably not gonna fuck you.
Yeah.
She's probably gonna respond very politely. Yes. And I'm pretty sure that she. She's looking hot as that. She's more approachable than girls that are actually mid, and that you think that they're more approachable than her.
What are you killing?
No, we can bring guns, man. So like, you don't have to care about.
Yeah, bro.
I don't know all about that, Bruca. I mean, Fragment. If you're in my Discord, you can come into the call if you like, Fragment. And if anyone wants to tap out at any time, just let me know. Just go in. Fragment would like to come in whenever. No big deal. But Fragment, I'll drag you in. So you go into the Discord, like, general chat, and I'll drag you up.
The general voice chat.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
No.
No wieners.
You don't have to know. You don't have to know. I didn't even ask you that. I just know because I see how you respond to people and how you interact with people. So I know that even if a weird guy approach you in a Walmart, you will be respond kindly and you will be you will interact with any person.
There's a lot of because you variables
because you're like you're
there's
like
no
that.
Gun because violence like in that. Canada though, so she doesn't have to worry.
Hey, bro, can you chill with the gun violence? Yeah, we're not talking about
all the guns there.
What is cryo? Cairo, sorry. What did you say?
I just mean, is it all about guns now? That, you know.
No.
I don't understand.
No, it is not.
What would mean a lot to me is if I see somebody that I like walking down the street with a bunch of dogs, we're golden. Fucking golden.
Oh, just wait till I tell you how many I have here.
Are we talking about golden retrievers? Or what are you talking about?
Well, Labradors are the best ones, but why would
you need weapons?
But I'm telling you, no, it's about grace, no matter what. Even if I thought you were a very bad person, I'm certainly not going to provoke the situation. I'm just going to extricate myself from said situation. GTFO.
Yeah, that's the first fucking option, Dossie. You know that.
Well,
get the motherfuck out of there. Yeah.
Respond with grace.
But you have to be tactful about it. You have to be tactful about it.
I don't want to talk.
Just because you know Dossie. What's up.
That's not her
Doesn't
name.
Doesn't mean
but,
you have
oh
to
my
show what's up.
God, she impressed me.
I'm going to make a cup of tea. Be right back.
Okay.
I don't know what that means.
Okay, I can agree with you.
Yeah, let's leave guns out of this. We're not going to mention guns again. Because... You know what? I'm from Canada. Someone's from the UK. Someone's from Serbia. Okay, there's some guns in Serbia, but guns are not
a
thing.
I wasn't talking about guns at all. He is mentioning I don't know why the fuck is he talking about.
Well,
all right, Tim.
Again, the puppy in him.
Guns.
Okay. I'm gonna bring in.
There's many other ways to resolve.
I'm stronger
situations.
Than you. Let's see.
Wrinkly.
Many other ways.
I'm, like, giving you warnings here. I don't know how else to tell you. Calm down.
You said all I could do is show guns if it's.
Okay,
no.
You showed them. You showed them. I heard that. Okay. So,
all right. Yeah. I don't.
Let's bring in Fragment.
Any fucking rules. So.
All right. What do we got here? Fragment.
I can relax on the profanity, but
please.
I didn't break any.
You didn't. Just relax
rules.
A little bit. You're a little like. You're a little. What's the word? Like high strung right now?
Little antagonist.
Just calm down.
Little antagonistic, yeah, Dossie, that's a good word.
Just calm down.
I love you, though. I'm not saying that I don't.
More rambunctious than antagonistic.
He's rambunctious. He's excited. Fragment. We have a fellow Canadian in the chat, a fellow Torontonian, actually. Welcome in, Fragment 37.
Fragment.
I have some Tim Horton tidbits. Very Canadian of me. I just had them. Very Canadian. I think it's reversed, but it says Timbits on it.
What are they?
They're like little donut holes. Timbits.
I thought so. They look very delicious.
Yeah. So I just had... That's from the road trip yesterday that I took. I normally don't eat that.
Where did you go?
Stale donuts.
they were half stale donuts. I went to Stratford and I watched a play. And spent the day.
God, super horny.
Wandering around.
What was the play?
Peter Pan.
What was the play that you saw?
Peter Pan.
And don't downplay it, dude. You had a fucking awesome day.
I did have it. I had a great day. Yeah. I was gallivanting. I was on one. I liked it so much.
You
I even
loved
took a
it.
I did love it.
Back
I even
to
took
the
a,
city.
I even took a video of the washroom. Like, guys, look at this washroom. It's so nice.
Man, I'm not some hick ass piece of shit anymore.
No, I didn't go to Toronto. I went to a small town. It was just another small town.
I know, but it's close.
Earth. That's cool.
Yeah.
You know what I did yesterday?
What'd
me
you
and
do?
My best friend hauled
all we
a
got
sofa
is cheeseburgers.
Down the road.
What did you do? You hauled what down the road?
A giant ass sofa. Lit and I and my best
it's
friend.
It's probably pretty windy too.
She's like, I go, I don't think we can get this out the door. And this is how we handle things. She goes, nah, bullshit. We're going to manhandle this. So
fuck
we
you.
Did. And I said, we don't have a trailer. We don't have a pickup. She's like,
what a bet.
Who cares? We're a block and a half away. Pick it up.
Strap it.
You walked it a block
strap
and a half?
Strap it together.
A block and a half?
Yeah.
And then she goes, we're moving the fireplace. What? No, it's 110 degrees. I fold. She goes, grab your goddamn end.
You're so Failure is not an option.
Failure is 100% not an option.
See, that's the kind of friend you need. Hey, when you need to move something,
that's
what you call. Because remember, you got some dibs on that. Remember you called, you made me walk 100 degrees, a count sign. Guess what? You're getting your butt here and you're going to move this stove.
Yeah. I don't fail when it comes to fucking moving, man. I've done
well,
it.
Well, it was
the
insane.
Hottest weather you've ever seen.
List,
and the coldest weather.
And
you've
she
ever
goes,
seen.
We're ahead of schedule. What
and
else?
I can drive 5 hours like, at a time. Darn it.
So
no
I'm just saying.
Fucking conditions.
I wanted to tune in. I got it, Anne. But, like, you were in my back pocket. it was crazy.
Dude. And that's like one of the many things I love about you. Like the rare time I do fucking DM you or anything, you know, You always hit me back. That means so much to me, you know?
I try to talk to everybody.
She does.
I can't explain that, like, you know, to anybody, how much that means. You know what I'm saying?
Like, it does mean a lot.
People know that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then there's times, like, go ahead.
I don't reach out to everybody. Like, if you support my community, if you're part of this community, I will talk to you. But, like, I just don't have time to talk to everybody, like, sadly. And that's where, you know, that there was a learning curve for me for sure. Because I was like, okay, now I have to make that tough decision where I just can't spark up conversations with people who don't tune into my Twitch streams
and
don't
watch my Twitch. You're famous now. You're still learning.
Yeah, so I do have to, like, I really only talk with my community members and people who support me, and I support them back. And that's, you know, you scratch my back, I scratch yours. So
I try to leave you alone.
Well, but here's the deal, though, Anne. It's not just like what you're saying, because when you do respond, it's not just because you have to write that thank you note.
Endgame, of
course. You are very sincerely and very authentically responding. It's not just bullshit. That's what I'm going to say about that. Because
she's the only grown woman I've met that's like truly not a...
Yeah, she's not like check my social networks and that stuff.
We're listening. I'm waiting for this word.
Mm-hmm.
I like that. Come on, Wrinkling.
yeah, you want to guess? You guess? You want to?
Frank, how are you doing?
Okay. Not too bad.
What's the word?
How many followers do you have now, Anne? You have several thousand.
I have over 6,000 on Twitch and on Instagram.
Okay. So
I was gonna say the two words bad streamer. Okay.
Yeah, all right. That's it.
What do you constitute? That's a bad streamer, though. What is a bad streamer? Lordy.
One that is a bad streamer. She's not one, so it's super easy. There's no...
What is a bad mod?
Houdini! Greetings and welcome, Houdini! Welcome in! What's a bad mod? Oh, good question! Me? I'm a bad streamer. Yeah. You're not a bad streamer, Houdini. You're not a bad streamer. What's a bad mod, though?
Well, I'm gonna stick around
that. Me too, Houdini.
That has wild
timing. No, you're not.
Pretty good. Pretty good timing right there, then. But now, Anne's like the most W stream. You guys, you have no idea. Like,
I'm sure they have a little bit of an idea.
Every fucking day, dude.
We watch her. We do.
I know we do.
Yeah, I don't think I would be here if I think otherwise, so.
Right.
Yeah,
nobody would.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you for being here. Thank you, everyone, for being here. Gummy, you have a pure heart, and I'm sincere. Thank you, Gummy. Welcome in Houdini, and welcome in Crypto Gamer. Hey, what the heck is going on here? Long time no see, Crypto. How are you, Crypto? We're here with Dossie, Bruka, Fragment 37, Lady Wanima, the real Mr. Cairo, and Wrinkly Beef. Oh, and Chi-Town, who is just audio only. We're just kind of
go White Sox. You guys are the worst team in baseball right now. You know that.
Is Crypto Gamer?
Yeah.
Pardon? Is Crypto Gamer? What's that, in Mr. Cairo? Yep, he's in my Discord. Yeah, he's in my Discord. He's come on some E-dates before.
So, and White Sox are... You're allowed to make fun of them? You are? Just don't make fun of the Cubs.
Okay, not the Cubbies. Houdini is like, oh my god, I can finally see Bruka's face! We don't get to see his eyes, though, but we can see his face. Listen, Fragment.
Oh,
we can see you. Houdini can see you. She's like,
I'm banned
see his face.
In Houdini's chat. That's pretty fun.
I wanted to ask Fragment. Earlier, when we were talking about dating and stuff, like, do you do a lot of internet dating? And if so, and if not... Thank you so much for your sub, Shvedi. Welcome in, Gundam. Welcome in, welcome in.
Right.
Thank you so much for 18 motherfucking months. It's my lucky number, Gundam. How are you,
Dossie,
and how are Lois?
Is that real? Is this made up?
Holy what, the shit. Dog?
No, Dossie.
What do you mean?
Fuck the dog, dude. I'm looking at her.
You okay there, Wrinkly? You okay?
I know.
Brother, I'll be all right, man.
I don't even know what's
going
on.
If you need
I was
to
fucking
yourself, go
bored
ahead.
For this shit.
No, but wait. Go. Anne was asking.
Fragment. Dating. What's up with the online dating for you?
It's non-existent at the moment, but when it was existent, it was very interesting.
How old are you?
I had a number of dates. Some of them, a lot of them were very odd people. Well, women, I guess.
you hope.
Some got.
Do you
really
know that none of them love
really
you?
Quickly. No, they got really attached really quickly, or they made weird statements, or like one said, hey man, like on the first date, she said, yeah. If you get tested for STDs, I'll have sex with you because I don't like condoms or
end
something
game.
Weird. And I was like, okay.
Yeah.
But she was weird on the date. We went to a pool hall and she was incredibly rude to the people at the table next to us.
Ooh. And you got an STD?
No, we're back at the rude people. We're back at rude.
I chose not to see her again. I just thought, okay, if you're going to be rude and weird to the people next...
I'm not saying he's red flag right now, surely. For me,
No. That's definitely a red flag. If a girl is rude next to people, especially you know to people at the restaurant working there, that's definitely a red flag.
Right, sorry, and Gundam says don't date 40-year-old virgins.
How do you know? Do you ask me?
Well, I actually don't know any 40-year-old virgins. I wouldn't know, but like I imagine they'd be pretty like I don't know. I don't like to use the word, but like kind of like fucking losers and shit.
No, but maybe awkward. Maybe awkward, right?
Yeah.
And maybe you are dealing with some awkward oddballs is what Gundam is implying, right?
Not like the kind of people that I hang.
Doesn't sound like they fuck, Fragment, frankly, you know?
By definition, yes. That's
well, wait a minute. If you ask us about STDs and what now, the first date, maybe you can
that kind of bullcrap, then you're banging the wrong chicks. That's all I'm going to say.
I'm sorry. Banging?
Banging!
Rocking
clearly on the first date.
I don't know, whatever the heck you're going to say. Man.
You're banging a tree if you're a virgin at 40 years old. So.
No, that's not what I said. I'm saying like
what, baby? You
know, no.
Well, I'm catching
the
terminology. I think would
that's
be
what I was saying.
Okay. The terminology
having unprotected sex with like a random person. Yeah.
I thought that was called smashing.
Good.
That's just
okay.
I don't know, man.
Okay, let's
whatever you
okay,
want.
Let's back up. Let's address the elephant in the room. We all prefer unprotected sex, right? It's just that we choose
that's what we're talking about.
The person that we're gonna do with. It's not just some random
shoes.
Person, right?
Of course.
No shoes for me. Shoes off, socks off, dude.
Well, I think we were back at the internet dating and these things. Then we got sidetracked with the sex thing again. So let's go back to the strangeness and whether you ever met somebody that was that you liked.
Yeah, what about you, Ian?
Oh, well, what about me, the strangeness?
When's the last time you jumped out of a plane
happened?
Fucked some super hot dude?
I've never jumped out of a plane. Okay, so there's the first half.
Would that be a first date?
Jumping out of a plane?
The rest.
Ooh, the adrenaline rush that you would get from jumping out of a plane.
I'm working on mine.
would be amazing.
Figuratively, dude.
No, literally.
No, she wanted to say that the rest is true. The first part of the question wasn't the truth, but the other part of the question is true. So, you know, she's banging a lot of dudes.
I'm waiting for.
She's banging a lot of dudes. Yeah, man.
I'm waiting for a tall, hot guy to message me.
He's coming with too.
Yeah, I'm waiting for tall, hot guy.
I guarantee you this. I'm not jumping out.
I'm gonna be jump master. I've already calculated the altitude, and I'll have the camera as well, right?
Okay, guys. I want to hear. Do any of you have like the craziest? Experience I'm meeting someone online and then in person.
How many shall I relate?
Yeah, how many? What's the limit?
Fragment,
No, I'm talking about the craziest experience.
Limit is four.
Yeah, like what happened? What is your craziest experience? Like, obviously, most of us,
Anne's my first, Anne's number one.
We had that experience. Like, what is the most crazy one?
I have it.
Most crazy one ended in divorce.
Anne is my favorite.
It's true. Wrinkly, we met through an interesting situation. Very interesting situation.
I've pissed her off a lot too. You know.
Look at her face. She's like.
But yeah, I don't know. I trust her, and she trusts me. So.
Good.
Right.
Bruca, to be honest, like there's like majority of my meeting people from online have been very crazy just in general. So, but it depends on what kind of stories are you looking for? Are you looking for ones that end in a romantic situation or ones that are just like off the wall?
At the end of the day, people who aren't going to sell you out, that's who I fucking appreciate.
Yeah, like romantic situations, something that happened and that...
No, I don't... No. That's where you can miss me with that shit, man. That's the one fucking thing you should know about me with Anne. I do not think of her.
Bruca, on that thing, you may have heard my craziest story.
I get
already.
It, man. I understand it. I totally do.
What is it? Can you remind me? I don't think I heard that.
The craziest one was I talked about this, I think, on Wednesday, during girls' night, was my ex-husband. I thought it was a really great date, and he told me a few days later that I was too fat for him.
Yeah,
but apparently, since I played Mario Kart with him in the movie theater before the movie, that won him over.
Now we're talking about Anne's giant rocking tits right now.
Oh, okay.
That's what you're talking about. You're not paying attention to the rest of the conversation. Okay.
Yeah.
But that's my story, Bruca.
Okay. So you met this guy online, right?
Yes.
And then, you know, you got married, and that happened after that, right? Am I following right?
What happened after, fucking Socrates? Happened after I got married is where, like, if things weren't crazy before, that's when shit got completely wild.
Right.
And, like... That's a whole nother.
That should have been your first red flag there. Like, do not pass go. Do not collect $200.
Listen, okay. This is what I told everyone else for the day. I love red flags.
Yeah.
Red's one of my favorite colors.
Oh, yes,
yeah, we kind of ignore the flags sometimes, right? Especially if there's
less
involved, you know.
All girls are attracted to red flags. Let's be honest. All girls are attracted to red flags.
Not all red flags, but some of them are interesting.
American flag.
Yeah.
No. You have that thing in you that you like to fix things.
Girls like to fix things.
Women do like
to fix things. I just love fucking America, you fucking dumbass.
If someone's a little bit messed up, you're like, I can fix them though. They mean well. They have good intentions. They have a good heart. They just need a little help. Yeah.
Well, why am I going to
a bigger heart than you?
Boring
a bigger country, man.
You fixed it.
Yeah.
That's why I got divorced two times
because they tried to fix me. But,
two times already? That's tough, man.
Yeah. But I have an interesting story about that online dating. My crazy experience. So I was 22 years old, 21, something like that. And I was playing like the World of Warcraft game, right? You all heard about that.
So, you were 21 and playing. Wow, yeah, I know the story.
So, but this was long time ago. I get it.
Yeah.
Keep Irish ranking, let him go.
Mr. Cairo's lighting a fire right now. That's so cool. Anyway, go on.
Yeah. 21-year-old playing WoW. Okay.
Yeah. So the funny thing is that there was one chick in this guild that I was, or where I was playing for, and we were talking every day, playing the game, this and that, and then we decided to meet each other, right? Because we were from the same country, from the same city, right? And we seen each other, right? And we started dating. And what happened that I didn't know that she was like total lunatic, right? From a girl that she tried to choke me literally with my pillow during the night when we did the sleepover. You know, she was sleeping at my place.
Like when you're having sex or no? When you're just sleeping?
No. While I was sleeping.
Ooh.
While I was sleeping.
That's were the police involved? Right?
That's terrifying.
Yeah.
That was terrifying.
Wait, what happened while he was sleeping? Sorry.
Some psycho tried to choke him, smother him with his pillow when he was sleeping.
Yeah.
That's a red flag. That's a red flag. Yeah.
That's probably best to leave that situation.
I mean, we were dating after that for a month, but yeah, that was like.
Sorry. What?
After she tried to kill me, we still dated. You know.
But she played a part in me. Attempted murder.
Okay,
I have another story.
Murder could have been a mistake. You know, play it one more time. You know, play it fun, right?
Right.
No. But she told me. But she told me that she's like crazy. Like she even had like the papers. You know, she was visiting the doctors and everything. So she had basically, the thing is that she had like those really terrible nightmares during the sleep, right? And every time she was waking up next to me, she tried to kill me because she thought that I'm gonna hurt her, right?
She was sleep smothering.
It was really toxic relationship, but I survived, right? It's a really crazy story, right?
That's crazy. They turned to attempted murder. And by the way, Houdini said that she loves the color of your bikini, Dossie. She loves your orange bikini.
Thank you.
Yeah, and yeah, Skiz says date turned to attempted murder. Crypto calls it foreplay. and by the way, the real Mr. Cairo, did you just light a fire because you saw Dossie lighting some incense?
I've got incense. I thought, that's a good idea. I've got my fan on. I'm going to blow some incense around the place. Yeah.
Not bad, buddy.
Trying to get rid of the bugs. They're all like getting in somehow. I think I need to get some caulk out tomorrow and get a ladder because this is bullshit.
Yeah, that's all the benefit of living in England. There's no bugs. None.
Or at least spring.
Well, that too. They'll go away from the incense. They don't like that.
Mm. What do you need back there? You're fine.
They're on the ceiling. But
is that a bad deal.
But you know what? We've all ignored red flags. I've had a whole parade of them and went, wow, they're marching in step.
The thing is, for a guy, red flags are something that we're willing to, forgive go pass about that. And for girls, it's not like that. If you see a red flag in a guy, like you're like, I'm done. You know, I don't need this.
Shakespeare, crazy man.
Is, red flags in a guy like
this day in America.
You like sticking your stuff in crazy.
Just be crazy, bro.
Some people like that. No.
Gundam's like, I heard cock. And Rael's like, cock out.
Yeah, yeah.
Rock out with your cock out. Get rid of them bugs, Dossie.
There you go, Royal. There you go.
Break out the citronella candles, Dossie.
They're outside. I can't bring them in. Because I'm in an enclosed structure.
Aw, such a cute doggo, T says. That's Bailey. The mini Australian Shepherd.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you don't have...
She's combat sized.
If you don't have a cock, you don't know what she's talking about, so...
She's a woman. Yeah, my dog is a woman. Thank you.
But here's the deal. I gotta say this about that.
My dog does not...
A lot of women know exactly what it takes.
I know. Yeah.
I'm saying that there's a lot of women that run a lot of male energy, and it's...
Is that why you're all so fucking mean?
No, we're not mean. I'm just saying.
I'm just joking around.
Gundam, we watched it in the movie channel for Discord. I had it in my movie night. We all watched it two Fridays ago, Gundam. It was great.
Can you explain that phrase?
They did say flick the bean.
What it means.
No, I've never heard of it.
You know exactly what it means?
No.
Wait, what? What does what mean?
Who are you talking to? Are you talking to me?
Yeah, I'm talking to you.
I'm just saying that...
Girls know exactly what it means. What were you...
Here's why I say that. Because we are expected to be women, mothers, wives, girlfriends, and we have to work twice as hard. We're expected to be the same as you.
Woman.
A lot. The same. As tough as you. Suck it up. Get in the game. To even be respected. That's what I'm saying.
I don't know. You're a pretty tough guy.
I'm a guy, and I never try to compare those things, you know, things that I do, and that what I provide in a relationship.
You couldn't even begin.
And what I expect from a girl. I never compare those two things because they are totally different. So you have strengths in some other fields that we guys don't, right? So what I provide is security, stability, you know, loyalty, and
government adjacent security.
What I'm saying,
but the thing is, the only thing that I expect from a woman, from a female, is loyalty and support.
I love
those
that
are the only two things. Yeah. Only two things. Of course, but
I'm saying,
Dossie is not our mom, dude. She's...
If we were supposed to be side by side, I have to do twice. And of course, we all want that knight in shining armor. Are you joking? Of course we do. But we also know...
I got first dibs on that, so...
We also know...
No further applications.
There's a very strong possibility that that's not there. Therefore, we have to know what you're doing, what you know, in order to provide, in the event that somehow you leave, something happens to you, we are responsible.
We need water.
At the end of the day.
Yes, but I also know the thing that if you start to measure those things in a relationship, that relationship is doomed for the failure.
No. I think you missed the point, brother.
No,
I don't think so.
It is.
No, the whole point of the relationship is that none of those things run out.
Contributing more, and who is doing what? If you start measuring those things...
That wasn't what I was saying. I was saying that as a mother, at the end of the day...
We need eggs.
If you're not there...
And chickens.
It's on us. We want you to be there. If you're any kind of a man, We want you to be there. We want the stability. We would love to have somebody lean on. But what if you weren't? And I'm not saying because you're a bad person. I'm saying you got called home early.
I'm gonna say that. You're a bad person. What type of a man you are if you're not there for your child, and for a woman that that is raising your child? I'm saying that as a guy, as a man.
Life in jail.
No, dude, this isn't fucking Albania, dude. Relax.
No. Like, it has nothing to do with the country. I'm saying you have a very healthy relationship. Everything's perfect. And God forbid something happened to you. Something happened. You didn't
take
leave.
Take care of the fucking farm.
I feel better than that.
You got equipment.
Even owe you more.
You can take care of the fucking spot. You know,
no.
If anything happens, Darcy,
no, no,
you
know,
to take
finish,
the motherfucker care of it, right?
Let her finish, please.
I'm just saying that's what it would come down to.
These Europeans don't understand this.
No. If something happens to me, what? Tell me what? Well, what are you alluding to?
We have to pick up the slack.
Your families aren't allowed to own land. So that's probably
no.
Like
we have to know
matter.
How to take care of Lady. Everything. Like if something were to happen to you, then if you were supposed to be taking care of everything, we would be like kind of clueless on that. So we have to be right there beside you the entire time, doing the exact same things, if not more, to make mm-hmm. up to make sure that if something did happen, like, if something were to happen to you, there would be no gap, there would be no nothing if we could pick it up and go type thing.
No, you can never replace a real guy, a real man in a relationship. Especially
sometimes
in
you have to though. You have to take on that responsibility, that task if he was to disappear.
You move on and you find another guy.
That's not always the case. That's not always how it happens.
Fucking Kenyans where I work, dude.
No.
They're not good at the job. No, I'm not joking.
Yes, guys are
I'm saying
compared to women. Yes, okay, G, it does go both ways.
It does.
I'm a CDL
saying,
driver.
Say I loved you forever. I loved you till the day you died. And then you died. I don't have time to
I don't love them though, Darcy.
I don't have time.
Right. It does go both ways.
Grieve over you and not
take
care of the children.
Like $15
you're still grieving.
Less an hour
but than... this person is. Yeah. I'm responsible now. It's on me. I didn't want it to be that way, but it is. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, they give me the fucking dangerous truck that needs two inspections before it can get driven. You know, so I'm the only one who can drive a 15-speed transmission. That's fine.
Our kid's life, you know. If I'm gone.
Arigato.
What did he say?
He said that you need to replace...
It's your responsibility also is to move on and find another father figure for our kids when I'm gone. That's your responsibility.
Yeah, cream pie, a bunch of chicks.
It is.
Yeah, fuck it, dude. Heard
it's
that.
It's not that easy.
It's not that
yeah,
easy.
Yeah, because
not
you can't remember.
What
if to take care of children that is not his own?
Yeah.
That's a big deal.
That's a
plan
huge...
accordingly.
Okay,
yeah.
So
I mean, let's be realistic.
Yeah,
me as a single guy dating somebody who has another man's children, I really have to love not only her but that man's child. If I'm not willing to do that, you better stay there. You better not walk into that.
Yeah. Yo, shut down.
How many
also, you know what they used to call me, brother?
That could be
a pull-up king, mate.
Like, back to what we were saying earlier, that could be
if
a red
decide,
flag of
if
you.
We decide, yeah. If we decide to have a relationship with a woman that have children from
I ain't coming in
scenario,
nothing.
I'm going to accept those children like
no.
They're mine.
Never have.
Yeah,
I mean,
that
every
man
is willing to do that.
Right.
No
not
coming.
A lot.
I mean,
that goes against.
Well,
you
pull
that. Well, I can't stop
spreading
their
DNA. Like,
yeah, no coming. No coming.
The guys in this world, I'm talking about myself.
Zero.
I wouldn't give a fuck. I would be there, and I would be the father figure.
Yeah, until you get a chick pregnant. Like,
but that's great. And that's great.
then his life is ruined.
No.
But I'm
no,
saying
listen,
we prepare.
I'm not saying this to be great and to be
I
nice.
Prepared for nothing.
I'm saying this because yeah. that's my yeah. opinion. And that's how what I would do.
And it's very commendable. But that is so rare.
Not yeah. not jizz They're inside rare. Them. It, yeah. it is rare. That's an yeah. easy
it
decision.
Because some guys go after vulnerable women with children just for that fun time, and then they move on. Some guys that's
not
that,
even a fun time, man.
New guys, that was a game plan.
Can't do that.
I know she's wrong.
Okay, so
unless you're super smart, then you can try it.
So if you're that type of weasel of a guy that needs to win over a female,
okay, no more, no more cum talk. Relax.
Yeah, you should. You know, you got people. You know, which is
shut up, everybody. No more coming.
We're not talking about coming. But
no.
What?
I think we veered off a little bit.
Differences.
Oh, business right now. No more of that. That's my bad.
Just a little bit.
Everybody.
Yeah.
It's just differences. That's all.
It's hard to wrangle. The more people that come on.
Let's talk about squirts.
Nobody's talking about that.
Where in the world are you, Wrinkly?
Wrinkly wants to talk about that, apparently.
We're not about
squirts and guns. That's what he wants to talk about.
Yeah.
We viewed off quite a bit. Oh boy, it's about pumpkin time. I think it is almost pumpkin
squirts
time.
Squirts and
yeah.
guns, yeah. That'd be yeah. fucking it badass, it actually.
Boobs and guns, let's go.
I have to.
What is squirts and guns?
You have to put. Sorry, you have to put who to bed?
I don't know.
Birds.
The birds to bed, yes. Oh, I've got to put the babies to bed too.
They're fucking
all of you
birds.
Guys being the babies.
but you know what?
I can't go to bed by
this
him.
Has been awesome, and it's 11:11. This has been awesome.
Make a wish.
I loved meeting all of you.
Right.
Still even though early. We didn't get much from Frag.
Yeah, I didn't want to.
Frack.
We didn't frag anything.
Nobody
great.
It was a good weekend for me to be on because I've got time, but maybe another time.
I met some fucking cool ass.
Yeah, I wanted to ask if frequency or fragment if you stream, but I mean I'm assuming that you do with the headphones and the mic. But
no.
I don't want to assume any.
No,
I
he
actually
doesn't.
Don't. I'm on Discord every day in certain channels.
Yeah, I bet you are.
But just for the you know entertainment, I'm not doing anything you know weird.
The fun. Anyway. What's the poster in the background?
Oh, it's Seven. I collect. Yeah. I've started.
I don't speak Japanese, so
Japanese
is
movie
that seven?
It's so seven. That's seven.
Is that seven?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
I was like, it looks like seven.
Seven, and I've got Silence of the Lambs, and I've got Hannibal.
Lotions.
And then I realized, yeah. Wait a minute, I'm only collecting serial killer posters.
Is that red flag?
Red flag.
You're gonna fit right in here.
I go to a poster shop to get these, brother. Get them framed, right? And I thought, and there's this woman there, and she's kind of meek, and I thought, my God, she must think I'm a psycho, but. I have my eye.
No way, you think that.
You're safe here.
Fragment has been here for a long time, Wrinkly. Fragment has been subbing to me for at least a year. I met Fragment.
I've never seen his background, though.
I know. He doesn't come around that often. I met Fragment IRL last year around this time at Fan Expo.
Nice.
So I met Fragment in person.
Yo, yeah. So you guys hung out this weekend? Or no?
Oh, and you're still alive. So he is not a serial killer, right?
No, he's not you're a serial. I met him at a public place, at a convention,
yeah,
guys, at
shut
Fan
the
Expo.
Motherfucker.
Okay, it was a public place.
There's a child.
He's probably
the...
very nice and probably has a lot to say that would be beneficial to all of us, and we just missed out.
He's a social worker. He's a social worker, and yeah, I met him with his son, who is also hilarious. Both of them have great banter. So yeah, I met him with his son, who's a cutie. He's, how old is your son now, Fragment? 12, maybe?
No, 11.
11, okay. He's just getting at that age.
He's going to start jerking off soon.
Christ.
And we're hoping
to beat your ass, Frank.
Not in a bad way. I'm
hoping to hit it this year as well, but I don't know. It depends on what his mom wants, but ideally we'll hit it again. He's already plotting weekends so that we can do this.
He probably wants to do PC.
Or he wants to do.
Nobody wants to do PC.
I don't know what that
is. What is PC?
I'm afraid to ask.
Don't ask.
No.
I'm afraid to ask. Oh,
okay,
too.
Okay. Why you said what his mom wants?
They're divorced.
PC part. Strategically.
They share custody.
Okay, but why is it?
They can build it. Teach him network security and everything, because so he's not looking at
you
like.
You have to be
porn.
Give and take.
Online,
yeah,
because it's custody. They share.
Yeah.
Yeah, I understand that, but the important thing is what he wants. What he wants, not what his mom wants or his father
wants. He's 11,
he's not really an adult.
He would probably love to go out to four in the morning every night.
At least when you're from America, because when you're from America, your parents buy you things. So let him play
Xbox until he figures out, right? Don't pressure him about it.
I can see, Bruca, like, you would be that type
of
parent.
If you're in school now, man. Like,
you would be that
type of parent just to go to fucking school.
Yeah, I wouldn't pressure my child to be anything, Dad. I wouldn't reflect my disappointments in life on my kid.
I'll just teach my children to throw a 90 mile an hour fastball. That's the thing that people mostly do.
Yeah. Oh my, you know, I don't have any children, so I don't normally assume what I would do or assume, you know, how other people should raise their children.
They would be the best baseball players.
Because you know
ever,
what?
Man.
It's completely, they probably would. It's completely different though. If you have a child, you know, if you are a parent.
You can have an opinion about it, but
you know, like.
You need two kids and about $1 million.
Parenting is different. Like once you're starting to do it.
They're expensive.
I'm just saying he's coming to the age where he's, you know, we're starting to accept what he wants, you know. I mean, you know, he wants to play
video games 17 hours a day.
We're not cool with that, but you know, we do listen to what he wants, and if he's
punch him in the fucking face till he goes to sleep.
Sure. No, don't do that, Wrinkly.
I don't think we do that. But
I would do that to Wrinkly. I would do that to him. But yeah, go on.
You too. I would hate to see a sleepover party with you and Wrinkly, Bruca.
Yeah,
Wrinkly
would
be the one getting
smothered.
I'll kill you in all.
In game. In GTA.
Well, I want to see Frag
nice.
Again.
Crypto, congratulations. Crypto's getting a new grandson in January. Wrinkly sounds like a great babysitter. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's awesome, Crypto. So yeah, I see what you're saying. He's a young man now, Fragment. So you have to take his considerations, you know, or take his ideas into consideration. But yes, within reason.
What is he heard yet?
I think we'll convince his mom.
I have a very important question. Does he train any sport?
Yeah, he plays soccer.
Gay.
Okay, great.
That's the right answer. He's from Serbia. Yes. Total European. He plays football or soccer.
Oops.
He's okay. He's all right. He'll be okay.
I said gay.
No, honestly, I'm not in a group of sports, but yeah, you know, soccer, you know, it is fine. It's a good sport for a guy.
Yeah, he wasn't. He didn't want to play hockey, and I didn't want him to play hockey because it would mean I'd have to get up at 6 a.m. all the time, and I'm not really down with that. But I'm just kidding.
That would be great. That would be great if you played hockey and could be waking up at 6 a.m. because he would need army
to
and
get
discipline.
CTE. Yeah, that's how you know you love America, man. When you get your brain broken.
It's a good sport for anyone.
No,
you are right,
not,
G. It is a good sport for anyone.
Not brain broken, but
that's real football,
to get,
brother.
To have discipline, you know. Waking up early at 6 a.m., going to training and training hockey.
And running scout team against guys that are 245 pounds playing running back. Yeah.
Oh, my.
Okay, Ricky.
I'm just getting murdered.
I do have to tap out.
Yeah.
So I love you all.
Okay.
Bye, Dossie. Yeah.
Bye, Dossie. Thank you so much for
that's
joining.
That's real football, man.
I'm going to end as well, so I'm just going to go back to full screen. So I'd like to thank Bruca. Dossie, Fragment 37, Lady Winema, the real Mr. Cairo, Wrinkly Beef, and we have Chi-Town on audio as well. Yes. Thank you so much, guys. It's already past my bedtime. Pumpkin time was 20 minutes ago. Have a good night. Love you all. Appreciate the conversation.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Shvies. Bye-bye. Okay, hold on, guys. I have to activate my... I'll see you guys over in the chat. Thank you for coming on, okay? I'll see you back on Twitch. Let me just activate my camera. This should work. Yes! This worked! Alright, guys. Oh! That was hectic. That was hectic. And we're back. Maple Marie! Greetings and welcome, Maple. Oh my god. The problem is when I bring on more people, Data, when I bring on like more than like one person, I can handle one person. Mr. Cairo, fun time indeed, indeed. I can handle one person. Once we start to bring on multiple people, multiple conversations, I want to clip this. It's so difficult. Like, I'm great one-on-one, but what, like, if I have six people, no, it's not your bad at all, lady. It's not, it's nobody's bad per se. Oh, it's just so hard to really, like, rein everybody in and hone in a conversation and then to keep chat, to read chat and focus and interact with chat at the same time when you have like six people. It's damn near impossible. It's damn near impossible. Whack-a-mole! Any kind of fool will see there was something in everything about ya. Six conversations at once, pretty well, Crypto. That's what it was. That's what it was. Whack-a-mole, good evening, Whack-a-mole. Welcome in. So, it's hard. Oh, I don't know. I just found money. I just found money under my mat. That's nice. I'd like to find that. Anyway, I must have put it there for safe keeps. RIL tip pog. Yeah. You know when you like find money in your wallet or like in your jacket or somewhere and you didn't know you put it there? I must have put it under my mat. So I just found some money. Some money, some Monopoly money. Okay. Darn, I hate finding money. It was not, it's my money. Viva! How I wish that there were more than 24 hours in the day. I also agree. I wish there was more than 24 hours in the day. We've got some holographic money. Actually, I have to say our money's pretty cool. It's, washable. Why would it be? It was just, I put it under my mouse pad and I forgot about it. I put it there for my trip yesterday and I guess I forgot to put it in my wallet. I only find money I don't remember having after a good night out. Well, I went out for a trip yesterday and I guess I didn't bring it with me and I left it under my mouse pad. $200 ain't found money. That's emergency money misplaced. Yeah, exactly. Well, I brought it for my trip, I guess, and I didn't pack it. I didn't bring it with me. Can you peck flex and talent? No, I cannot peck flex and talent. Sorry, first time chatter. Yeah, so it's the rainy day fund, yeah. So, this is fully washable. Like, you can wash this money. It's plastic. It has a really cool hologram on it. And then it has these little, like, braille things as well. Good evening, M-Horn. I was... think doormat. I don't know. I didn't know you could wash it. Oh, yeah, Fragment. You can wash this. It's fully waterproof and washable. Mm-hmm. That's cool, I'd collect it. Yeah, so this is the $50 bill. This is one of our old prime ministers. Who the hell is this even? I don't even know. Somebody. I have to read that. Who the heck is that? Mackenzie King. Premier. W.L. Mackenzie King. Prime Minister. Some old Prime Minister. Mackenzie King. Anyways. Man. Oh, King. Yeah. It's King. Mackenzie King. And there's like... Anyway. Old Leather Dude. That's it. We got Old Leather Dude here. Mackenzie King. For something that is meant to be unbreakable, they rip really easily. They do rip easily. But they're fully waterproof and washable and stuff. They're like, do you guys know that tickets? Like, you know, like when someone puts a ticket under your, like, windshield wiper? It's like that material. It was worth it. Chat, have a good night. You as well, and good night, Rotamal. Thank you for joining Sweet Dreams. Why are you flashing Monopoly money, Zell? I literally just found it under my mouse pad. I had it here all night and I didn't know. I just found it. So. They crease really badly too. Oh, they crease horribly. These ones are fresh. They don't have any crease marks. They don't have any. Oh, this one actually does. Okay, you want to see a crease mark? This one does. There you go. It's all creased up. See? Is that what the UK money looks like? Does it crease easily? The British, like, pounds? Anyways, I know you have Canadian Tire bill somewhere. I know you have a cupboard full somewhere. Not anymore, Zell. No, I don't collect Canadian Tire money anymore. I used to, though. If it warms up this week, we will have to go to a Toronto Blue Jays game. You're going to a Toronto Blue Jays game? I'm not going. I'm going to a wedding. All weekend. I will have to follow Dossie. She was very interesting and entertaining. Give her a follow, Shy. She is interesting and entertaining. She is wonderful. She's wonderful. I've modded 3 Twitch truckers. Job is no joke. Yeah. It's all plastic now too. Is it? It's all plastic money? Yeah, it creases easily. You need a beach ball for your gaming room. God, M Horn. A beach ball or a balloon, right? Because you're into balloons. M-Horn, no. I don't want a beach ball for my gaming room. Sorry. You will have to do a swap. Ooh, a money swap. Good night, Maple. Were you here all night? I must have missed you, Maple. Anyways, the doggos would destroy that in no time. The beach ball? Yes. Yes, they probably would. They would destroy that in no time. Guys, who are we going to raid out to? Tell me that. Riddle me that. I'm sad. Why are you sad, Maple? You were quiet all night. What happened? What happened? Pineapple Hoops. What about Pineapple Hoops? What happened? You know the Albertan Hula Hoop streamer? She's Canadian. I know her. I've never really watched her. Is she okay? Is she okay? What happened to her? She was doing a push for partner or something last I saw. Oh, raid her. Oh, why are you sad, Maple? Oh, sorry. We got a raid going. But why are you sad, Maple? I'm not gonna say why I'm sad, it's just a guy thing. Oh, I see. Hi, Nisa Shvidi. Does anyone know Julie? Looks like we're gonna raid Julie. Hey, saw your Instagram profile and figured I'd stop in. How are you? Bucky, welcome in. I'm just raiding out. Guys, I'll be back on Tuesday, 8:30 Eastern Standard Time for my paint and song request night. I don't know Julie. I don't know her either, but we're gonna raid into her. I'll be back. Guys, thank you so much. Exclamation raid. Copy this little thing. Let's raid into Julie. Alright, so guys, love you all. Thank you for all of my guests tonight, especially Dossie. appreciate thank you to everybody. I love you all, okay? Thank you, Bucky, for the follow. Good night, guys. Sorry, it was fucking hectic. Not one of my best e-date nights. I need more structure than that. I'm much more of a, like, structure girl. I'm much more of a structure girl. I'm going to enjoy my 2 days off, and I'm going to paint some names on my 2 days off. Okay, I'll be back on Tuesday. I'll see you guys then. Enjoy. Good night. See you next one. I'll see you Tuesday, Data. Thanks for being here. I love you all. Enjoy the rest of